audio first.
Yay.
Browser that exists. Browser Whew. That exists. Browser. All right, chillin'. It's gonna be time soon. It's gonna be time soon, bro. I'm so hyped.
Oh, hold on. I need to change my nickname again. Hello, it is in fact Jilly Repair, not Jensun. Good warm-up from Virginia.
We're gonna download these warm-ups. We're gonna have them play. It's gonna be lit.
Very ready.
Into my downloads folder. Please put them in the place.
Any Gwinners? Plus DT, yeah, definitely. Any Gwinners?
Where owls know my name, DT?
That's DT, viable. Bro. That's any Gwinners? Any Gwinners?
I mean, Dust Ice DTFC'd this, right?
Dust Ice, yeah. No, I think he like slider broke the end or something.
2037 combo, 2038 max combo. I'm pretty sure that's. Or no, excuse me, 2035 of 2038. I think he dropped a couple slider ends.
There's a lot of DTHD plays. They all break at like 1400 combo.
Wait, why does Eris... What does Gaze have a 15x50 A rank FC with max combo?
That's what it's all about.
Holy crap. Yeah, that's like your phrase. Did you know that? That's like your yeah. phrase. That's what it really it's all is. About.
Maybe you should just make me stop talking halfway through the stream. He's saying it again. Make him stop, please.
Hey, everybody. Clear's doing the thing. Please make him stop doing the thing.
Whatever it was. It was like 2 days ago in VC. Aaron and I were in here. And I kept saying literally. And I told him to tell me to shut up if I kept saying it.
The problem was I couldn't get the shut up out over the chorus of literally that he kept spouting. It was too Well, it's okay though.
Yeah, it's fine.
Could be worse, you know?
Could be worse. We could have SoCal bracket reset 7-0 twice.
Yeah, imagine.
That would be the worst possible situation.
Imagine if that happened. That would be.
That would be awful.
Oh man, that'd be.
Like, wait. Nothing against SoCal here, but that would be obnoxious.
I want to see a competitive game of the OSU.
I unironically would like to see Virginia win.
I would like to see. I just want a close match. Honestly, that's all I want is a close match. I want whoever doesn't win to get many points. But I don't know. The SoCal boys probably have other things.
They probably got a couple FCs up their sleeve today, but I imagine Virginia does as well.
I think Virginia's pretty good. I think.
Yeah.
I think Virginia is a deeper, rounded team than Ohio was last night, and Ohio got 3 points, so I think Virginia can. That being said, SoCal could just do the SoCal thing, and it could be completely uninteresting. But I hope that doesn't. Our referee is still not home. He knew the time that this match was going to be. This match wasn't rescheduled. He knew the time this match was going to be from literally 6 days ago. So I don't know why this is an issue, but we're chilling. It's all good. We're gonna talk about stuff and hang out. Chat is not on screen. Chat is indeed not on screen.
We don't need you.
We don't need you guys. Also, I've never put chat on screen for this. Screen anyway. I also don't think I have chat on screen for the pre-match.
That's fine. It looks clean without it.
Also, just realized the music I think is going to restart when I switch scenes because it's going to be a different source. Because I had to redo it for the white instead of black text. But I want to listen to this song because it's.
I'm just here listening to my empty tournament client right now, listening to Real.
Yeah, there's other.
There are others, but Kali
has like
the one.
Kali has like solo carried this tournament, to be honest.
Yeah, he deserves it more than anyone. Sorry, Nick, you've done a lot too, but
Nick is the 4WC custom lobby ref.
Yeah, he's done so many custom.
He did all but one of them, which I think was like 7 of the 8 or something like that custom lobbies there were. Nick did, and it was just because people specifically asked him. He's like, they're like, hey, can you ref a lobby at this time? He's like, sure.
Dude, I was checking, if you guys haven't seen the 4WC sheet, we're not gonna link it, but I believe that entire section of the sheet literally just says Nick's lobbies.
Yeah, it does. It says Nick lobbies.
Nick lobbies.
Okay. I need to know, how do you create a poll?
Creating a poll?
Yeah. How do you create a poll on Twitch?
Like on, like a straw poll?
Like in your chat, yeah.
Oh, can you do that?
Yeah, but I don't know how.
Oh, here, let me see. You can do, it said something about slash vote.
I don't care
about,
oh, voting, oh, it's on your dashboard. Okay, you have to go to dashboard. I don't use dashboard. Oh. So.
For whoever's gonna win.
Channel needs affiliate? No, it doesn't say that.
No, it doesn't say that. On your dashboard for your first poll, click create new poll.
Manage stream, stream manager, quick action. See, manage your poll, add. Manage poll, create a new poll. Who will win the grand finals?
Of 4WC.
Option 1, Virginia. Option 2, South California. Duration's gonna be, you can do 10 minutes maximum.
This channel can, in fact, get partner. I'm
Service
pretty sure
error.
We meet every
Try
single
again
requirement.
In a moment. Let's go, dude.
Yeah, we met every single requirement for partner.
There was an error creating the poll.
Oh,
I can't do it.
We should be able to.
No,
refresh,
it's just a service.
Refresh.
It just says service error.
Maybe refresh the browser.
I'm refreshing. We're gonna find out. We're gonna make a poll.
We're figuring
it.
This out.
We're gonna make a freaking poll.
This channel does in fact do streams. We are streaming currently, as Nick has mentioned, and we are in fact going to be streaming for a long time tonight, at the minimum probably 2 hours.
Duration 10 minutes. Start poll. I can't do it. It just doesn't work. It just literally gives me a service error every time. This is so sad.
Sorry. Everyone, just put in chat what you want, what team you think will win. Just let's get some good spam of each state name here.
After the tourney ends, when will the next tourney start?
Next year. Yeah, next year.
Yeah, USC is an annual tournament. That being said, there are talks about hosting a North America draft tournament.
Hi, how are y'all doing?
At some point, probably like winter after NLBC.
Yeah.
So stick around for that potentially. I actually would probably think about hosting it just on this channel or something, to be honest. Any idea where we can see the team lineups? ! Spreadsheet. Or ! Sheet. Or ! Teams. Any of the above will work.
Try ! Vaxe while you're at it.
I don't even know what ! Vaxe says anymore, to be honest.
I think it says Vaxe. I think it says all three or something like that.
Yeah, I think it does. Let's see. Yeah. It's giving me the chat rules. It's my stream. I know the chat rules.
I got it. Hold on. All three, all yeah. Vaxe.
Wait, so it doesn't say anything about polls not being available. Oh, maybe it's an FAQ. Oh, it's an FAQ. Why are they only available to affiliates and partners? That's so stupid. Like, why does that need to be a thing?
Darn. Well, there are going to be warm-ups for both of these teams here. Playing with Ruby will be South California's warm-up.
Yeah, SoCal warm-up is playing with Ruby, and Virginia warm-up is apparently where owls know my name, DT. Gonna
nice.
Be lit.
It
oh, they're already all in the lobby. Holy shit, that was fast. Yep. Wait, I need to show this screen. I didn't even show this screen. Here, we're gonna go to this right
here. Oh, here, we're gonna skip through it. Here's the matchup, everybody.
Here's
These are the two teams.
It's really loud. Oh god, it's really loud. I didn't realize they were just gonna instantly all join, because that never happens in a million years. All right, I have to go announce the stream. So yeah. Prepare for typing. At everyone, it is time for the grand finals. Virginia versus South California. At pipe. Also, the pick'em is now up for the bracket base set. And Fox. So
the match is starting after warm-ups, which probably 5 minutes. Before the first warm-up is done, and then we'll go after that. Maybe we should have told Virginia no, because Rivers of Neil is... No, it's fine, actually.
It's fine with DT. Yeah, it's okay with DT.
Yeah. Let's go. So that's a long map.
Yeah, it's a doubling time map, so...
I'm currently watching Beast Troll MC on his stream FC, the map that you're all thinking of. Which is, in fact, the Deceit.
I was gonna say, what map was I supposed to be thinking of?
I don't know what supposed map to be thinking of when you think of Ed. What map do we think of when we think of BTMC?
Not the Violation.
Well, right now it is with 93% accuracy. Interesting warm-up map for SoCal here, testing the waters with some of that less mechanical stuff. Stuff? Playing? Map style? Sergeant R already breaking?
Yeah, it's a warm-up. I'm not really too worried. So, do you think they even play the Violation? Does that get played?
Yeah, if it's not banned, I think it gets played.
Because, like, I think the strats for this match are going to be really interesting, to be honest. So, I don't know. We might.
There is a high chance that we do see it played, but it's definitely something that I'd be surprised to not see. SoCal has inherently banned that Nomad 2. And even though that is, you know, been their classic way of going through things here, I wonder if they're going to mix it up a little bit against Virginia. I doubt they're going to stop banning Nomad 2, especially on a team against Tony Rectigon and BTMC. But there is a complete difference between Nomad 2 and the Deceit with just the speed and the stamina. So those two maps are kind of like in categories of their own almost, where you could pick or ban one and it would have zero effect on, you know, your decision to pick the other.
Hey.
This warm-up.
This is an interesting map.
This warm-up is a very difficult map.
Vaxxay and Monko are actually going... Oh, just kidding.
Both break. Now it's just Monko.
Vaxxay got slow-slidered. Yo, Monko? Yo, Monko? Any other Monkoers? Just kidding, he broke too. Alright, well, so, I think the strategy here is really interesting. You know, we saw Ohio, last night against SoCal, banning out speed maps, right? They banned number five, down from the sky, they banned the Violation. Virginia, I think, is better at speed than Ohio was, and I think they might just leave those maps up, because I think what Virginia is worse at than SoCal is actually not the raw mechanics maps. I think Virginia is worse at the gimmicky maps, and I think they might just ban, like, Nomad 3, Nomad 6 type of things. I think SoCal does stick with the Nomad 2 ban, as you said, and then they might ban DT4 again, but I don't think Virginia is as good at DT4 as Ohio was, so that'll remain to be seen.
Yeah, both of these teams here, I don't know.
SoCal could go, like, Nomad 2, Hidden 2, because Virginia's actually probably decent at Hidden 2 with guys like Tony on the roster. And they banned Hidden 2 last night, so they might just keep that ban, but I think they do ban Nomad 2 this time, even though they left it up last night, because Ohio did make them pay for it, and Virginia's better at Nomad 2s than Ohio is.
Yeah, you also have the situation right now where... Virginia is the winner's bracket team going up against SoCal, so they actually have an MP link for SoCal from their previous match, so they have a easier time figuring out what they want to go with here for picks and bans, whereas SoCal is kind of in the dark about Virginia. They have only previous rounds to go off of, and I'm not sure how high effort they are in terms of spreadsheets and research and stuff, so, like, other captains are, so there could be a massive advantage for Virginia in that area, but if SoCal put in the effort, it might not matter as much. But you know, Virginia definitely has a little bit more to work with here.
I think it's actually just tough.
Can't wait to get this.
And I think SoCal, since it's grand finals, I think SoCal just probably plays around Vaxxay. Like, whatever he feels good at, they just pick. Kind of like what the USA does in OWC with him on the roster. Because, like, he's your win condition, right? Like, Vaxxay is just the win condition in unto himself. Boy, that was an interesting map.
That was a map, by the way. Someone did point out at the end that Tony was actually mouse onlying that warm up. There was only mouse buttons used.
Oh, MP Link isn't up.
Oh, we'll have to get that.
Oh, okay, lagging. Edit, MP. Okay. Oh. There you go. Yo, I can run a 60-second ad break. Who wants to watch an ad break?
Let's do it. See y'all in 60 seconds. I'm gonna go take a nap. Where owls know my name. Honestly, we could take a 60-second ad break, come back, and this warm-up would be no further in. And this Twitch channel would make no more money. Wait for Where Owls Know My Name with, in fact, DT.
Is this going to be some Vaxxay mode right here?
Yeah, is this going to... Oh, he already missed.
Tactical int
from Vaxxay. Rectigon, however, not tactically inting the beginning. Neither does Monko. Sergeant R, as much as I would totally love to say he's not tactically inting, I also don't think he's going to FC this. As he misses the first stream, there you go. Rectigon with the highest accuracy aside from Vaxxay.
Dude, imagine Vaxxay just FCs the rest of the map after missing at the very beginning.
Imagine the nope, he misreads. Right. Rectigon, though.
He's probably sight reading this. Gotta imagine he probably hasn't played this before.
Yeah, probably. This is not exactly a common map to DT.
This is like lots of BPM 10.3. Lots of BPM meaning 240. Actually, yeah, not 240. It's 239.985.
Oh, okay.
Because this map is 159.99 BPM. Unironically,
you know
on the website.
You know, on the beat map submission requirements, it does say that your beat map must at least be timed correctly to be accepted, and some mappers take that very literally, apparently.
Maybe over the course of, because it's a 6 minute long map, like that 0.01 beat per minute, like over the course of 6 minutes is probably actually noticeable by the end. They were probably why is this out of sync at 5.5 minutes, but it's not out of sync at 2 minutes? And they just tried dropping it by 0.01 BPM and it fixed it.
I mean, rock definitely does that. Just like the difference between electronic songs and that, just the computer generation and the exact timing.
Yeah, right. The nice thing about playing EDM maps is that they're always perfectly timed because there's next to no timing required.
Yeah, really.
You just
get
the BPM
going,
right in your
studio.
Set.
Yeah, just hit the BPM and just be like, I want this to be 160. Done.
At dictate. Is this accurate? At dictate.
I can confirm in FL Studio, to set the BPM of a song, you quite literally just type in the number.
The one person I know who makes music.
I'm watching two FCs on this map with DT right now currently, and both of them are DTHD, of which there is not a single FC on. The highest DTHD combo on this map currently I believe, is Kodama at about 1,400. So there is a chance that we could be seeing the two highest combos with DTHD on this map, depending on whether or not Monko or Rectagon breaks here. It is, 1,715. 1,400 is the second highest, but there is a lot of people that have 1,400. Oh, there goes Rectagon, but
wait,
Monko holds.
Vaxxay and Monko both held through that. What the fuck are they on?
Monko's FCing.
So this is like Virginia figuring out if they need to ban Nomad 5.
this is basically what
they're doing right now.
I think the only difference that this map makes compared to that is the 10.3, I feel like.
It's not as fast. Violation's 270, so it's 30 BPM lower.
It's 30 BPM lower, but the high AR almost makes it seem like it's faster. In my mind,
yeah,
at least.
10.3 is hard.
I'd like to point out, by the way, that in a couple of seconds, Monko 2K will have the first DTHD FC on this map.
He doesn't have hidden on. What are you talking about?
Wait, why does he? Oh, he has no fail, bro.
Like, you can see him. You can see approach circles on his screen.
You know what? I don't pay attention enough.
He literally has hit circle.
I know I'm blind. Shush,
Monko
Badoo.
Just FC'd that, by the way. Monko just FC'd that, by the way.
All things aside, Monko just FC'd.
Fuck, he FC'd. That's not. And Vaxxay one missed, one slide of Rogue.
All right,
SoCal pretty good at speed. SoCal pretty good at speed.
Monko 2K now has the third best double time FC on this map, and he did it with Score V2.
Yeah, that's let's see, 93.34% accuracy, so not very good, but that is 500 PP for that. With Score V2 in a warm-up for a Grand Finals match. I mean, like, honestly, that's not a thing you're supposed to do.
Yeah, if that doesn't tell you how this match is going to go for these teams, then I don't know what. Yeah. There are some very high combos.
Yeah, that's rank 3. Actually, I wonder if that would have beaten Gaze's score, because Gaze had an A rank FC. So his, like, even though Monko had lower accuracy than him,
the 100 placement in the 50s.
Probably would have been lower score. So it would have been ranked 3 DT. That's insane, though. That's actually nuts.
Very impressive. Which Vaxxay there are 3. There are, in fact, 3. Monko, 2K, Idki, and Vaxxay. In reverse order from right to top.
Is there a way to like, overlay player names via OBS such that Vaxxay2 and Vaxxay3K are replaced by Idki and Monko2K? Because, like, honestly,
I can just imagine this Comic Sans text over the names covering it up so we can show the actual ones. I'm sure most people know by now, at least with the name changes, especially on Idki, but...
Oh, look, Nomad2 immediately instantly banned. What a surprise.
Yeah. Saw that coming.
So SoCal won the roll. They get the first ban, second pick, and they instantly ban Nomad the second. And now we're gonna see the Virginia strat. And I think it's a weird map ban, but after seeing that warm up, it might be a speed ban.
We could see Nomad 5 now because of that, but I also wouldn't be surprised if we saw something like DT3 ban.
I mean, DT1. Okay, so this is big brain. DT1 is actually the same BPM as that warm up they just played.
Ooh.
They're both 240, and Virginia saw what SoCal just did on 240, so maybe they say, let's ban DT1 now.
It's gonna be big. I think if Virginia doesn't ban DT1 or 3, I think they're not banning properly, at least to the full extent of what they could.
This is really interesting ban strategy in this match, because Virginia is actually pretty good at DT, as we've said. They have Rectagon, they have Tony. But SoCal DT is, like, actually ridiculous. Oh, not sure. The strategy is really... And like you were talking about before, having the benefit of knowing that you have the bracket reset potentially would let you switch up your bans if it goes to a second set. If you miss ban in the first set, you can say, okay, we should have banned this and this instead. So you do have the ability to change that up if you need to.
You know, the funny thing is, I'm realizing right now, they joked about it in chat, but they could ban Nomad 1.
Nah.
Genuinely.
I don't think Virginia bans, like, aim. I think Virginia either bans weird or they ban speed. I don't think they ban aim. They looked pretty good on aim in the past weeks. Like, I thought they looked solid on, I know they played, I don't know if they played much AIM in
I think they're gonna ban Nomad Sticks.
Finals, but I know they did in semis. Yeah.
I think Nomad Sticks.
Like, Nomad 3, Nomad 6 are kind of up there. And it's Nomad 3. All right, let's go.
Oh, yeah.
So the first ban is going to be Ouroboros. You know, we saw what SoCal did on this map last night. With... why is it not coming up? Are you serious?
There's Hard Rock 1.
I know they played this. Okay, I swear on my life they played this last night, but maybe they didn't.
Maybe they didn't. I don't know. Hard Rock 1 is definitely a decent ban against Virginia with the AIM and Hard Rock ability of some of their players.
I was thinking of... Wait, what map is... I was thinking of Nomad 6. We know what they're capable of on this type of map from last week, though. And interesting, Hard Rock 1 ban from SoCal. I don't think we've seen them ban that type of map at all.
You know what I'm thinking from Virginia right now is probably something like Free Mud 3 against SoCal. I wonder if they're just going to be good at that type of map, at least compared to being able to tank something on Vaxay with a Nomad. But they could also still be looking at DT.
I was looking at the wrong pool. That's why I said Ouroboros. It's Iro, Oshinata, and Machi. That's what happened there. But Nomad 3. I for some reason had the finals pool open. But yeah, Iro, Oshinata, Machi. We saw what they did on that. Yeah, actually.
Yeah, I think... I'm really thinking for a team like Virginia against SoCal's previous performance, Free Mod 3 is probably something that they would ban. I think just based on SoCal's performance yesterday, Free Mod 3 would be the realm that they're looking in if they're looking to ban what SoCal is good at versus what they can't play.
Yeah, like, low AR breeding gimmick type of stuff is, I think, the difference maker. And there it is, Free Mod 3, good call. Yeah. The release of the Far West Ocean, that is the kind of weird, it's like tap aim. I don't know how to describe it exactly, but it's a short, kind of strange aim free mod pick. It's quite difficult with mods and
Vaxay 800k.
Vaxay 877k, almost 878k came in and Nomad slider broke with two 100s. Like, you have to keep that in mind when free mods are up. And interesting, Virginia's gonna first pick Nomad 5. So our first map is going to be the Violation. So Virginia is saying, you know what, we're actually this good at speed.
I think this is a smart pick from them. Given what I just saw in a couple of streams, I imagine that this will be the Rectagon Tony BTMC triple here for Virginia. I saw BTMC get, 2,300 pretty reliably. Tony is good at this type of map, and Rectagon has just come out of nowhere and absolutely destroyed speed and stream maps like this. So I imagine that all three of them are going to put up at least, 1,500 combo on this. But the question is, will SoCal do the same or better? We just saw Monko get the third double time FC ever on the warm-up. And... this map is in fact faster, but the streams are more straightforward. You don't have to handle the 10.3 reading. So there's a lot more in terms of what Monko is probably capable of doing, as well as the fact that, Vaxay's FC Yomi Yori, which in the sense is a similar style map. It's big jumps with some fast streams in the middle. And Idki is just good at this type of map. So you're going up against the three that are insanely confident at something like this.
My only concern for SoCal is actually, we know Idki is really good at stream maps, but I don't know what his BPM cap is these days. I don't know how high he's comfortable with BPM. Vaxay and Monko, yeah, they'll probably both be fine, but, we'll have to see. We'll have to see what Idki's max end stream comfort BPM is.
Yeah, this would be good to see from him.
I think he can probably play it okay, but there's been times I've seen him uncomfortable and stuff at this kind of type of BPM before. Yeah. So it's gonna be the core three for both teams on this. It's gonna be Rektigan, Tony, and Beastrol taking on Vax, Aid, Kimonko. That's gonna be the six players I think we're gonna see the most of in this match. And they're gonna be the ones getting it underway with this slow little dramatic string intro build-up moment here.
You know something I do think, with some previous performance from some players in SoCal as well, you argue that Iggy's BPM cap might not be as high as he wants it to be for this, but something we haven't mentioned as much over the past couple of days and weeks of this tournament is that Iggy's accuracy has suffered quite a bit on a lot of maps in this tournament. So I wonder if that's going to be a factor in something like this, where players like BTMC and Rektigan are pretty proficient at this BPM and their accuracies will be able to hold fairly strong. But then again, they are going up against Faxe and Monko, who this speed is kind of their forte. Dangerous way, waters they're treading into. As Monko does find a
first break, though. That was a bad early miss. Like, he just misaimed on really not a very difficult pattern, so that's not where you want to be breaking. It kind of feels like Inting to miss on this map, this early.
This early, yeah.
Your stamina is not going to be running out as of yet, and it's not really difficult in terms of aim.
Ooh, Rektigan and Tony both cider break.
Monko found another break for himself, but Vaxe and Nikki both holding on just fine, as well as Beastrol, whose ACK is suffering, though, down at 93%. He breaks as well. And this is going to be the Vaxe Idki show now, as they are the two FCs left and both holding pretty decent accuracy, 96, 97%. This is a Vaxe FC map, not going to lie. Because he has the speed and the stamina for this map, and he slider breaks. Okay, well, it's an Idki FC map. What am I talking about?
Vaxe was actually Bancho.
He popped back,
but Virginia.
Actually, everybody at Virginia
BTMC
popped back.
Oh, Tony's back!
So,
what?
I hate Bancho. This is making tournaments unwatchable, but Tony came back and then missed again. Ed never missed to begin with. Neither did Iggy or Vaxe, and Monko is getting his combo back up pretty high as well.
Yeah, this is unfortunate in terms of just accuracy for Virginia. BTMC does find a miss, and Rektigan has the highest score, but he's going up against two FCs and Monko with just that early break. SoCal is absolutely dominating this map as BTMC's combo comes back after he Bancho misses for the second time.
Nice.
So it's BTMC on Virginia compared to two FCs and then a third basically FC right now. We're just over halfway through the map. There's not too much Virginia can do about this except for hope that SoCal decides to completely under or overstream something or miss on a jump. Right now, Vaxe with the highest accuracy in the lobby by a decent amount for FC terms. SoCal is doing what they are trained to do and what they've trained themselves to do, which is just come in an FC map. BTMC is slider breaks along with Vaxe and Monko. But there's nothing Virginia can do.
Vaxe's just Bancho missing all over the place. I don't
know. Neither
did
BTMC.
He still hasn't missed. Neither has Inki. So, anytime we see a slider break, we're just going to assume it's not actually a miss, because everything that shows up as a slider break is actually just Bancho.
BTMC might have actually just missed.
That might have been a real miss. None of the others missed there.
Tony was Bancho there, but Monko's earlier miss was not Bancho as well. So this is on Rektigan and Tony to hold combos.
And Idki and Vaxe are both still FCing, so it's, irrelevant what anybody does as long as those two hold on. And, this was the dangerous waters, and this was also kind of testing those waters, though. I do think that you leave this up and you pick it to say, we're going to see what happens with this. And then if SoCal beats you on it badly, then you can ban it in the second set if it comes to that. But this is Vaxe and Idki just absolutely destroying kids, because it's what they do in Grand Finals. Idki, I think, overstreamed that stream. I think that was a real miss. He, overstreamed and no-lucked the next note or something. Or understreamed the last note? I'm not really sure. That was odd. There is some combo on Rektigan who, we still don't know if what breaks are real. I think those are all real breaks that we've been seeing over the last few seconds, though.
Yeah, the stamina just seems to be dying out on Virginia. SoCal have all broken, but at this point it doesn't really matter with those earlier combos from them. BTMC's got a decent score at the ending here for Team Virginia, and he's going to top score for his team, but there's not much you can do against a 650k and 550k from SoCal here. Monka with a combo as well to combat. There is nothing Virginia can do. This was decided, when the halfway point of the map came and all of SoCal was still FCing.
Well, and Yeah, I think.
There's not much they could have done about that, honestly. With a one misplay from every single person on SoCal and BTMC finding a couple buzz slider breaks, the early misses from Virginia did kind of do them in there, with the slider breaks, the buzz sliders for Rectigon at the very beginning, and then BTMC. There's not much you can do when you hit something like that, because unless you're really comfortable with this type of map and your timing is spot on, it's really hard to make sure that you can confidently hit those. But SoCal gonna go for the exact same map basically that we just saw with the Necrogoblicon map.
Well, just as goblins, we saw the I believe SoCal picked this themselves last night because they it's a BPM they feel good on, it's a map Vax they feel really good on. He one miss with 99 accuracy. So this is a very SoCal pick. It's high BPM, Vax Nomad good scores on it, and they just run on the back of that.
I think you had a good point with Virginia testing the waters on that last map, because I feel like at the same time, that was one of the harder maps that we've seen in this pool. But, I don't know how much Virginia has really opened up for themselves by picking the Violation to start, because as I did mention, Nomad 2 is gone, but there's a couple other maps like Freemod 1 here that are completely different. The songs sound similar. The feel of the map might be, in the same realm, but it's definitely completely different from picking something like that. So, Virginia, I don't want to say they could have like wasted a pick on that last one, maybe, but there's not much that has been revealed to them by grabbing that. Mods are about what you would have expected for this. Vaxey's gonna Nomad tank again. Inky's gonna run with the Hard Rock and Manco at the hidden. Rectigon, unsurprisingly, on Hard Rock for Virginia. Tony on the hidden, and BTMC gonna tank the Nomad. Tony has missed early, but so did Manco. So it's basically dead even between these two teams, with Virginia on a little bit of a combo advantage.
Yeah, and we saw it. So I think the thing that Vaxey missed on last night, he's not gonna miss on again, because he'll played the map now. So it's going to be the other players, it's going to be the mod players that I think we're going to be watching here. And as you said, the mods are what we would expect here. And it's the Virginia early combo advantage, but it's so hard to keep your combo up throughout this map. As Ed and Backside both break, or were those both Bancho?
That was
Were those
I
both
had
real
breaks on my
misses?
screen as well. That was unfortunate. Tony breaks with the hidden again as well.
Interesting. So Vaxey not going to replicate maybe his score from yesterday, but you do see Idki and Mongo holding on against just one tabby trash, aka Rectigon, with the Hard Rock still intact.
Yeah, this is Ooh, and there goes Idki, so it's actually Rectigon now.
It's a little 1v1 here. Rectigon with the combo advantage over Mongo. SoCal in the lead for now. They do have pretty solid combo on Vaxey matching up with Beast
Mongo
Trolling.
Breaks.
Oh my god! He
Oh,
just
Manco just
missed
gone.
That entire pattern.
So, Rectigon is actually basically doing what Idki did yesterday with Hard Rock on this map. He comboed almost the entire map and only missed the ending. And what's happening with Rectigon right now is he also has two teammates that are completely backing him up in terms of matching combos. Because BTMC is exactly on top of Vaxey. He's a little bit behind in terms of score, but it doesn't really matter because they're gaining score at the same amount. The only real difference right here is actually, and there goes Tony breaking, so it's actually a combo advantage for SoCal. But Rectigon is going to be bringing this more in their favor with the FC.
This is a lot of pressure going to be on Rectigon here to maintain this Hard Rock FC. It's Ed.
Ooh, hits the one-thirds.
Oh, and Manco missed again. Backstand and Key did both hold on, so there is room for SoCal here, but Virginia going to maintain their advantage with that combo lead on those two players still by a pretty decent margin.
There's not a lot of time left in the map as well, and ooh, Rectigon completely underaimed that. He got nervous and shook off and underaimed it, so it's actually BTMC versus the world to keep the combo as he
breaks on nothing.
But BTMC breaks on nothing.
So combo
Everyone's
advantage,
breaking on the slow part.
Combo advantage literally just Vaxey going to try to bring this home in the last seconds. I don't know if he can bring back 70,000 points, though. there's not a lot of map left, as you can see. It's coming into the very, very end here. I don't think Vaxxay brings this back on his own. Even if he SS's the ending here, it's going to be tight.
This score is so close, though. Look at the 60,000 score difference between these two.
Oh, it's coming down so fast here with that Vaxxay combo.
Any break is going to lose this immediately for either of these teams.
Vaxxay casually exceeding the ending, but not enough. 7K. Virginia hold on in the end.
If Monko did not miss the ending there, he genuinely could have won that for his team if they both held, as Rectagon missed the ending.
Wowzers, so...
That was crazy.
That was very close, and I mean, it really just came down to the little things. If Monko hadn't misread that entire pattern earlier on in the map, if Vaxxay hadn't once again one missed, if he'd FC'd, like, there are so many little factors here.
Definitely.
But, I mean, Vaxxay, 755k yesterday, 674k today, that would have been the difference right there. His one miss was just 200 combo earlier, and apparently that was enough to change up the score by that margin. This time we see Rectagon hop fragging with Hard Rock, which is pretty amazing in and of itself.
That was very impressive from him. I don't think we paid enough attention as well. BTMC on the Nomad with a 1x slider break. There was not even a miss on him.
I want to say it was maybe two slider breaks, but yeah, very good play from him. So that is a couple break points to start things off. I think the second a little bit more surprising than the first. Now we're just tied up 1-1, so fresh set of downs here for Virginia. They get to think things over again.
Yeah, the two break points traded back and forth was not what I expected from this match. Taking their own pick is definitely something that you can see, but a break point for SoCal isn't something we've seen since their original match in, against Ohio. So an interesting, realm to go for here. They did, in fact, ban Nomad 2, so Virginia can't go back to this style of map even if they wanted to, but...
Hard Rock 2? Okay.
Not what I would have picked against SoCal. They have Tony and Rectagon.
Virginia has people who can play this, but man, SoCal put up 1.9 million on this yesterday.
And they lost because Aryu FC'd, right?
No, they won it, Aryu slider broke on this map. He S-ranked it, but they were able to win anyway because Vaxxay and Ipki combined for 1,400... 1.4 million, They had 736, 714k. So, very, very good performances to be expected once again out of SoCal. There are a couple of really tricky patterns in this that feel a little bit RNG, where you might hit them one day and miss them the next. So, it's definitely up in the air. And if Virginia feels confident on this with the kind of strange aim finger control, then, more power to them.
Yeah. Triangle in this map is definitely the pattern we're looking for here. That's gonna be the closer. Yeah, if that's the thing, if you slider break on that, there's a lot of combo that you're gonna miss for the second section of this map here, because it does come right around the halfway section. Unfortunately, it's like quite literally just before halfway, so missing there does inevitably lose about 250,000 score guaranteed. And here it comes,
and there goes
Antonio and Itchy.
Okay, so 2FC2 still alive. Just a combo reset.
It's close. It's accuracy advantage for neither team, basically.
Yeah, it's almost dead even. Beast Troll is dragging down Virginia with his 92% accuracy. Just a little bit. But the combo game is strong.
Yeah, it's barely going to matter if anyone on SoCal breaks here. God forbid Inky finds another break, or maybe even Monko. Virginia has full opportunity to take advantage of this. Inky and Tony have both recovered perfectly from missing that beginning pattern. And... ooh, I thought I saw a break there. I don't know why my game glitched for a second, but a very, very close match still.
The last quarter of this map gets so intense here that we're about to be entering into some of those square jumps and the slider aim and the space patterns. It escalates quickly, and that's going to be a break from Rectagon. Oh, but Malko follows it right up.
Ooh.
So it is BTMT now Vaxxay, versus Vaxxay. And Vaxxay has a 5% accuracy advantage over Beastroll. And he breaks, but they both break.
But everyone.
So now it's Vaxxay. It's Inky versus Tony on the identical combos, both holding through that. But it's going to be enough for SoCal.
Not even close to enough. Rektagon found another break after everyone else did. And it's just going to fully stay on the side of SoCal with no opportunity to break at the ending here. So kind of unlucky for Virginia, actually, with that double break to the one on SoCal's right at the ending. They had an opportunity to kind of keep that. BTMC held combo for as long as he possibly could. But, you know, Vaxxay after that, you know, that break well towards the ending compared to the rest of the people in this lobby just brought that in.
And just look at Vaxxay's accuracy. I mean, you score V2 is still mostly predicated on combo, but 98% accuracy is going to do a lot for you when you're competing against players at 94 and 96%. Like, that just looks really good. That kind of ACK advantage helps you out with those little points here and there. You know, he improved his ACK from yesterday and his combo, improved his score by over 100,000 points. Just those little things, you know, the map was only separated by 82,000 points. So the fact that he improved his score was actually completely necessary for them to win that pick today.
It really was. And it was very unfortunate for Virginia as well. If you look down at the bottom left at Tony with the highest accuracy on his team and the second highest in the lobby to Vaxxay, he would have been a very, very big player for them had he not broken on that triangle, the dense triangle, along with Idki. They had, you know, two of the biggest players for both of these states break on that beginning pattern, and any different outcome there, and this could have gone the complete opposite way. You know, God forbid Tony didn't overaim the outside one, or, you know, BTMC didn't find that miss towards the ending, or Rektagon misreading. That was all over the place for that map. And going into Lindworm, a map that, you know, kind of follows a similar style of the alternating awkward aim, like finger control style that both of these teams are kind of familiar with, SoCal is going to be looking for another good one on this.
And real quick, can I just talk about the fact that Vaxxay after three maps has three misses?
Wow. In grand finals.
Yeah, like, not too bad. Actually, I think Ed is, like, actually has fewer misses. Ed has actually one miss, I believe.
Yeah, on that last map, he slider-broke.
Ed has one miss, and the other two were S ranks. So his combo game is, like, not quite as strong, because he's getting lower combo, but fewer misses. So very high level of performance we're already getting here.
Yeah, Ed is almost, like, woey theorying this match here, where he's finding that one miss putting him just below, and it's kind of letting the score a little bit down. But
the Vaxxay method.
Fire Rage subbing in for Virginia,
map.
Apparently. I guess.
Yeah, I don't know what that was about.
All right, well, Kali said goodbye to him. Everyone say hi to Fiery Rage and bye to Fiery Rage as he slowly disappears from this match, as he did not sign up this year. You missed your chance, sir.
Could have been on NorCal again.
They could have won. You could have been here. You could have been here instead of Virginia or SoCal.
I think you would have needed Toy for that.
Nah, dude, Fiery carries.
Dude,
these.
I miss Toy.
Did Chez bananas too? Yeah, Toy is a. This tournament's not the same without Toy.
It's really
unfortunately.
Just not. It's not the same without the entire NorCal roster from last year. Fiery, Toy, Corim. Like, oh my god, all three of those guys being gone is. And, like, not to ignore the fact that Toru didn't play this year. And some really misses already. You talk for 3 seconds into this map and you see four misses already, so.
Yeah, that's Lindworm, essentially. There's not much you can expect from both of these teams except for the fact that Vaxxay's
wait, everyone from SoCal just...
Camp.
What the...
Did they? Oh, wait.
Everybody
wow.
with Vaxxay,
no, Vaxxay's back, yeah.
No, he held, but Idki and Monko both broke, but it's now Vaxxay versus Tony, which are two players who are both very good at this type of map, so no surprise there, but a couple more misses here for Monko. Vaxxay carrying with the 98% accuracy combo, but... We're going to go back over to Virginia for now. It's going to flicker a lot, though.
A lot. Actually, One Tabby not having a good time on this map. Unironically, One Tabby probably one of the players I'd expect to be very decent in a map like this. You know, he has unfortunately not performed to the best of his abilities in this tournament, I don't believe. You know, he's had a lot of maps that he's gone in for that would seem like something he'd be good at, but it just doesn't perform the way he wants to in a match. And right now, he's not helping his team too much by being the lowest scored by a decent amount over... everyone except for basically Idki.
All right, I don't want to step on you, but can I talk about the fact that Vaxxay is single tapping and has 99.25% accuracy right now?
Oh, he is single tapping. That's a thing
and,
right
and
now.
And Tony yeah. just missed, so SoCal is just going to win this. But what is Vaxxay doing currently?
Vaxxay missed as well.
He missed finally on that linear pattern, but it's actually fine. That was actually, really like, matter. Absurd what he was doing to that point. The Vaxxay method. All right. not a lot of combo anywhere. Tony with the break. One tabby doing yeah. okay, but Icky and Monka holding him off, and Vaxxay with that ridiculous accuracy, and the score is going to more than do enough for SoCal to find another breakpoint here.
I mean, you know, what do you do? Vaxxay is SoCal's trump card for a match like this. You know, even if you have two other players on your roster that are perfectly matched with the other team, you know, what are the chances that Virginia is going to have someone who can match Vaxxay on every single map? And that's essentially almost what they need from this. Vaxxay with 1-100, 1 slider break, 3 misses.
That's such a disgusting score.
You can't, like, most, you know, as much as you'd love to say it, nobody does that consistently in a tournament match. Vaxxay is one of the only players that can just come in and perform like this. And as I was mentioning before, you know, Virginia, the only way they really are able to take picks like that in this match is if you have a player that is able to hold off Vaxxay's combo. And as of right now, Virginia's only been able to do that once. They lost the break point initially. And to be perfectly honest, I feel like this was a little bit of a mispick. I think, well, no, this was SoCal's pick, but they had the breakpoint in the middle, unfortunately. But Virginia does, in fact, have bracket advantage, so I guess they do have a little bit more room to work with here. You know, we mentioned before the match started, SoCal does already have a MP link on the board for this map pool. So Virginia not only has the ability to look at that, but they also have the match here that they need to win before bracket reset. Virginia's, you know, maybe gonna find some ways to improve themselves in that bracket reset that may give them the opportunity to take a couple more points here, maybe even find the win in the end. But HD3, I guess they're gonna try covering every aspect of this pool here right now with the Yokespie map AR8.
Yeah, I mean, this was a map that SoCal left up against both these teams. They did suffer one of their lost points against Ohio on this pick. Ariu and Kablaze came out with some very good scores for themselves, but the map still was only 85,000 points different. So, you know, it was a matter of a couple misses here and there away from going the other direction. I think Any pick feels like a risky pick against SoCal because they're just so good at everything. But if you're feeling good on low AR on a given day, then that's definitely the way to go. I think if they're going to have a weakness, it's going to be that.
Yeah, I wonder if Chron05 is going to come in as he pops into the lobby. Yeah, this is definitely something I would expect to see him. And I feel like Chron05, I was talking to him before the match, he said he can pull up, you know, 600 plus K on this in a Grand Finals AR8. So I would love to see what he could do on this map, because one tabby, you know, not really going up to the extent of his skill on the previous map. Hopefully he's able to do a little bit better on this, but it's very nice to see that, you know, Tony's going to have someone capable backing him up on an AR8 pick. And I hope one tabby is able to kind of pull himself together for this map compared to the last one. I think he has the capability for it. And I definitely think that, you know, BTMC has made some massive improvements when it comes to AR8 lately, and I wonder if it might have been better for Virginia to have him in for this. But enough of that.
I think it just comes down to who's feeling the best on it on that given day, because it's still not a specialty skill set for Red by any means, and it's something that I think Chron is pretty solid with. But we'll get to see what happens here. I think eyes on Tony for Virginia, though, and eyes on one tabby to see if he can put up a solid score on this. See if SoCal can improve Tony? Their score from yesterday.
Tony breaks early.
Yeah. Vaxxay with the early break as well, though. He did the same thing yesterday.
Ooh, and there goes Matthew as well.
Okay, so 1FC, one big combo for Virginia just against the big combo for Vaxxay. Or excuse me, for Idki. That name will not stop throwing me off, I'll tell you what. Virginia gonna have the early lead here, and we'll see how long Chron and one tabby can keep their combos up, because that's gonna be very important as Tony struggles a little bit here, but Idki finds a break, so advantage no pretty combo. Heavily. Yeah, not a lot of combo for SoCalts. Vax a about 200. Matthew breaking once again. So it looks like this might be 2 days in a row that SoCal drops this point as Inky breaks again as well.
Two FCs for Virginia still on one tabby and Chrono 5 with the highest accuracy in the lobby. Tony breaks again. He's really not having a good time with this. But he's still putting up a good score. He's not too far behind Inky and Matthew, who have also broken. But there goes one tabby. It's quite literally all on Chrono 5 in the grand finals of United States Cup against South California. Chrono 5 is going to be the top scorer for Virginia no matter what. No matter what. It doesn't matter. He's still the top scorer.
Yeah.
But there's a massive score difference here, and there's not too much time left in this
map. Everyone from Virginia just wiped, though.
That actually
Matthew
lost
and Inky have some combo.
To
That's going
to
bring this back, actually. That is dead ass going to bring this back. Oh, you hate to see it. As Matthew holds on to combo here at the end while all of Virginia just dies, I don't... That's tragic.
It actually came down to Matthew holding this end combo. He's going to be the highest one on SoCal right here as one tabby slider breaks the ending. Virginia was so close. They had the advantage for the entirety of that map. And Chrono 5 top scoring that for them with an unfortunate misread at the ending. He just kind of over-aimed a little bit, which lost it. But, you know, as of right now, SoCal are only 2 points away from guaranteed tiebreaker and 3 points away from a bracket reset. As much as I would love to believe in Virginia winning it on this first one, I don't know if it's going to happen with the momentum that SoCal has. With that being said, I see zero reason Virginia does not re-pick this in the bracket reset if SoCal doesn't ban it. I think this was a very strong pick from them. I think, unfortunately, Tony had a very rough time at the beginning and middle of the map. He kind of pulled himself together during, you know, the ending of the map. But, you know, Chrono 5 and One Tabby definitely had their breaks at the ending, which weren't amazing for Virginia. But if Tony's able to improve his score in any capacity, there is going to be... a very, very high likelihood that Virginia is able to take this as another point in the bracket reset if it happens. Or Virginia could just, you know, sweep the rest of the picks in this match here.
Virginia could just win 6 points in a row here. I mean, there's no reason that can't happen, right?
Yeah, basically.
SoCal could just fall victim to a series of monumental blunders and suffer an unprecedented defeat.
This was a great performance as well. Chrono 5 has not really been off the metaphorical bench in quite a while in this tournament, and I'm very excited to see him come in and perform that well on a map like this. So it must say the, you know, people kind of rat on Chrono 5 for being one of the less useful, quote, players for his team on Virginia, but, you know, he has his uses, and Chrono 5 is a very, very good player, and most people just don't recognize the name. Especially when you're in a match with Vaxxay, Idki, Monko, and Tony, and all these known tournament players and OWC players, it's very hard to focus on the little guy like Kron. And, you know, when he comes in and does something like that in the grand finals of this tournament, it's hard to keep your eyes off of him now if he comes back in. But time for Gold Dust now as BTMC returns and Rectagon will return as well. Tony gonna be the sit-in player for Virginia today.
Yeah, Tony just plays everything. Dude's pretty good at the video game. We did see this yesterday, of course. SoCal putting up almost 2 million, while Ohio can only muster up about 1.4 million. So definitely a map that you would say favors SoCal, especially considering some of the misses they had were not the most fortunate. I think they could definitely improve on that score, as scary as that sounds. But, you know, Tony is very good at DT. Rectagon is very good at DT. Again, you know, something that on paper could be a contested pick if they can maintain their consistency, which is always kind of the struggle for teams against SoCal. Like, South California just out combos you a lot of the time on a lot of maps because they just have that skill ceiling to do it. So we'll see what happens on this pick here.
Some decent aim players for DT on both teams here. You know, Rectagon now known for his DT aim and speed. Tony previously known for that. BTMC, like, the up-and-coming DT ability from him is absolutely insane. You know, a year ago, nobody could have ever imagined BTMC hitting this and comboing over Tony on this map now.
but that's a bunch of misses.
Everyone on Virginia has broken except for BTMC.
Yeah, Ed has just dedicated himself to improving his weaknesses, and he's done a really, really good job of that. You have to admire the grind. But right now, just it's going to be tough to hold off Vaxxay and Manka, who are both continuing their full combos while the Virginia team kind of collapses around Ed at the helm here currently. 98.5 accuracy, still with the FC alive. They're basically only hope at this point, but Manko and Vaxxay, 99% FC currently. I mean, what do you do against that? It's tough.
Yeah.
And Manko not far behind us, maybe one or two 100s back.
I think Manko was actually the best scorer on SoCal for them on this yesterday.
He was.
So
he was by about
40k
over Vaxxay. They were the higher two scorers of the three. But there goes Manko. That is a break. So it is now Vaxxay versus Beastroll MC on a DT pick. I don't think I ever thought I'd hear myself saying those exact words, but here we are in 2020. Anything is possible.
I don't think Vaxxay breaks, though. Unfortunately, Ed does over-aim. He gets a little bit nervous. He shook off of that second one thereafter.
Now
he's kind of starting to lose it a little bit, unfortunately.
Now it's actually over.
Unfortunately, you know, even, you know, we can put this on BTMC for kind of letting it slip at the end for himself, but he's put up a fantastic performance. He's absolutely carried his state on this pick, and you really can't do much against Vaxxay, especially on that accuracy. There are not a lot of players that can FC this map twice in a row now. Like Vaxxay, he's the only FC left, and Manko's got a decent combo after his break.
Vaxxay just FC'd Goldust in the match, guys. I don't know what to say.
Yeah. Remember, like, what is it, a couple of years ago when this map DTFCing was, like, the coolest thing ever, and now Vaxxay just shows up? Love to see it.
Yep, that's fine. Like, I don't know. I mean, like you're saying,
you know,
like,
what?
Like,
I'm going to say it. This is what it's all about.
Like, that was not a bad score from Virginia. Like honestly, 1.8 million, I mean, that would have beaten Ohio by, like, 500K. And it loses to SoCal by 700K. I mean, that's just the storyline of playing against this team. You get Vaxxay with the FC, you get Manko with 760K, you get Idki with 660K. It's tough to compete against because anything you pick, that's just, there's the possibility of that happening.
Yeah, that was just, that was probably SoCal's most confident map in the pool. I don't really think there is much else that, you know, not even because SoCal is able to combo it, just sheer, like, insanity. It's their ability to play this map compared to every other state's ability to play this map is unmatched. Virginia put up essentially a team average of, like, 550,000, which on a grand finals DT3 at, you know, AR 10.3, you really don't see a lot of teams even coming close to that. But that just shows you the prowess of SoCal in everything that has to do with this match. We are going to go back to Fremod 2 for Widowmaker, the Black Dahlia murder, very similar to what we saw earlier from Necrogoblicon and Flesh God Apocalypse with Violation and dressed as goblins. But this could be good for Virginia again.
You know, it feels bad because we keep saying, like, this could be good for Virginia, and then they just lose the point. But, like, it's such a feeling thing, and it's such a like, spur of the moment. Like, this could be good for them, feasibly, but SoCal just has a way of kind of crushing that dream. But, you know, there's always the chance here, and another relatively high BPM. It's another free mod. You know, we saw Rectagon coming in on the previous free mod on Dresses Goblins and pretty much hard-carrying Virginia on that. So we'll see if he does it again, because he is going to be the hard rock here with Tony on Hidden and Beastroll on the Nomad pick. But SoCal keeping their same lineup, going to be Vaxxay, Nomad, Idki, Hard Rock, and Manko Hidden. So we'll see if Virginia can take another free mod. I mean, it's taken them a while to come back to this pool after winning Dressed as Goblins with SoCal's first pick, waiting all the way until their own fourth pick to go back to the free mod pool.
Yeah, this would be very interesting to see if Virginia is able to finally take a point on this. I think Dada mentioned it in chat earlier, and I definitely agree. This is the most similar map to Nomad 2 we have left in the pool, and I wonder if Virginia is kind of banking on that right now with SoCal having Bandit yet again. Because, you know, SoCal took they took the gamble yesterday. They didn't ban Nomad 2, and they lost it. So why not pick the next, you know, closest thing to it?
Yeah, I can definitely understand the line of thought behind this. And, you know, so far it's working out early on here. Virginia with the 3 FC is still intact, with Manko a little bit behind, giving them that advantage. So, decent play. You know, this is going all right. Obviously, ACK going to be at a premium, and there goes Rectigon. This, like, one-third stream is just tricky to hold your ACK and your aim together.
Especially Hard Rock.
So it's going to go back over to SoCal pretty rapidly here, as that is a lot of combo now gone. And you still see Vaxxay holding on, as well as Idki, with Monko not too far behind. Actually, hidden on this is just ridiculously difficult, so it's going to be a remarkable play for him to hold this combo.
Especially with Tony holding it as well. Accuracy not quite up to the level of Monko right now, but both of them, any FC on this
is insane. Oh, and
there goes that. Yeah.
Idki, meanwhile, holding almost 98% ACK with Hard Rock is insane. I don't know how the man does it. Not anymore, because those were like 50s. Interesting, the two hidden players just broke on the same note. Tony and Monko broke on the exact same note there. Clearly something that was a little tricky to read, perhaps.
It was right before the back and forth. Oh, there goes Idki as well, so it's actually just Vaxxay left for SoCal right now. Unfortunately, Rectigon not quite up to par in terms of combo with Vaxxay's FC right now, and unfortunately for them, Vaxxay does not, in fact, get slow slider there, so there's not much you can do about SoCal right now unless Vaxxay somehow finds the break of the century and Rectigon is able to FC the entire rest of the map with his teammates in tow.
Rectigon has to hold on and Vaxxay has to break for them to have any sort of chance here. And
Vaxxay has to break a lot.
Yeah, and whenever he's up by 300k, so like that score gap is still going to stay big even if he does break and Rectigon holds on. Just the 4% accuracy and the big combo is pretty notable. You know, it's funny when you say something like, oh, well, Vaxxay's the only one left. You know, that's really not that bad if there's going to be anyone left. Vaxxay is like far from the worst person. And that's going to be Vaxxay bringing this one on home for SoCal. That is another very strong score from him. I don't know how the man does it, quite honestly.
Yay, Vaxxay!
Who else? Can we find somebody else to talk about really quick? Like, no, because nobody's within 400,000 points of him.
Let's talk about BTMC, who is yet again one missed a map. A fantastic performance from him today, to be perfectly honest. We're not really focusing on him as much as we should, because, you know, all eyes on, you know, Tony, the consistently, like, known tournament player, and Rectigon, the up-and-coming god of tournaments, and then, you know, people don't pay attention as much to BTMC, good old like Ed over here, who has been around for longer than, you know, Rectigon, and has been playing and has made massive improvements in a lot of his skill sets over the past year. So, you know, we really do have to give him credit for all the stuff he's been able to do over the past year/less than a year, basically since OWC tryouts in the fall. He is, you know, you could go over his scores from it, they're not public, but, you know, there is a stark difference in his overall consistency from what we've seen before, and it's just amazing to, you know, to think this improvement is possible for those of you, you know, that like talk about not being good at AR8 hidden or like 10.3 DT. Like, you can go out and practice it and become really good at it, and BTMC has essentially proven that to everyone here with his performance. But unfortunately, you know, one player in a 3v3 tournament is not exactly what you need. You need teammates to back you up as well. And with SoCal going for DT2 for Escape, you know, it is the AR8 hit DT, so it really is focusing more on the speed at that 279 BPM. But this is a SoCal map, unfortunately, and I don't really know as much as I want to give Virginia a good, like, the benefit of the doubt. With Vaxxay averaging 1 to 0 misses like per map in this pool, and going back to DT, which is his skill set and inherently Monko's skill set as well, this is basically SoCal's match/map to lose right now, with only one pick left to bracket reset.
Yeah, and this is another very strong pick for SoCal. They, I believe, first picked this yesterday against Ohio, and Vaxxay FC'd, Idki broke at the very end, and they won by 800,000 points. Like, this was arguably their best map yesterday. So, I'm gonna say that we're looking at a quick bracket reset here, because this is a SoCal map through and through.
Oh, and, you know, unfortunately for Virginia as well, getting to that bracket reset
generally, what you see most of the time in bracket reset, there's two different ways bracket reset goes normally. There is either the team that was reset kind of pulls themselves together, realizes that they messed up a couple of picks, and is able to bring it back. Unfortunately, there's also the case where the loser's bracket team is just better and is probably going to do the same thing again, and unfortunately that's what we're maybe looking at for SoCal here, given that they've only let up 1 point. And what SoCal could theoretically do in the bracket reset is just ban the map that Virginia won and attempt to go for a 7-0 sweep here, as Rektagon does miss on a stream on the DT. That's basically it for Virginia here. I don't expect anyone on SoCal to find breaks besides maybe one or two players, you know, as Monko trades with Tony here.
Oh, Vaxxay with a surprising break. I don't know what that was. That was unlike him. That was a couple of breaks from Vaxxay. I've seen this yesterday. I'm surprised to see him missing it all in this. I mean, at this juncture, it's really not going to matter much because Ed and Tony both just broke and Rektagon doesn't have that much combo, but...
Yeah, BTMC with Iggy only.
89 ACK. 90 ACK on Tony. Like, this is just not going super well here for Virginia by any stretch of the imagination.
Vaxxay 3K is in fact Monko 2K. But this is an Idki map here. This is what we talk about in like the entire tournament thus far, where SoCal is one of those teams that quite literally has a guaranteed FC almost for every map here. And, you know, sometimes it's not the player you'd expect. Like, you know, Vaxxay is the player we'd expect to FC this, but right now it's Idki right now putting it's Idki. Up above a million.
Yeah, that was a big improvement by Idki, you know, by just not missing in the last 50 combo like he did yesterday, right? That's all that really differed there between today and yesterday. But SoCal just looking really, really good. I mean, that's like unstoppable tier in terms of that first set. And now it's tricky, right? Because now you go to bracket reset.
Interesting mental.
And so we're gonna have a short break in between, and we can discuss the concept of the bracket reset here. While we're in between, we're gonna have about a 5 to 10 minute break. So we're gonna hang out
maybe
here.
Even shorter.
It's gonna depend on the players how long that they want to take, but we're gonna hang out and we can continue this discussion. We're gonna flip it on over to our little pre-match screen here. And
looks like 5 minutes for the next lobby.
Yeah, it looks like around 5 minutes. It's going to be going to a new lobby, and we'll get a new MP link and everything, and we'll go from there. So SoCal with a 7-1 victory over Virginia in the first set here, coming from the loser's bracket in the grand final. They do go to the bracket reset, and now things get really interesting because your mental as a team from the winner's bracket is ostensibly going to be a little easier to maintain because you had, you know, technically in that first set, you really have nothing to lose. You can pick some stuff that's maybe a little questionable just to say, if this goes well, great. If this goes poorly, then we have a bracket reset and we can switch up our picks. That being said, when that first match of the grand finals is a 7-1 drubbing, that's when your mental is a little bit harder to maintain. That's when things get a little trickier and you want to have, you're going to probably have a little harder time maintaining your mental as that team that just got beat up pretty badly in the first match. So we'll see. It'll be interesting to see what happens with Virginia in the second set to see how they come out after a little bit of break to try and reset.
Yeah, they're going to have to kind of reset their mental a little bit here. There is a very bracket reset will not be a new map pool, nor should it ever be. That's kind of the point of a bracket reset. The way double elimination works is there is a top bracket and a lower bracket, and the loser's bracket team has to win twice because, you know, you have to lose twice in order to be knocked out of the tournament. So this was Virginia's one loss, and they have to lose a second time in order to be knocked out, whereas SoCal has already lost once, are in the loser's bracket, and only have to lose once to get knocked out of the tournament. So that's how bracket reset works. There is no third round, there's no fourth round, this is not like a best of like five match here. This is whoever gets their second loss first. So right now both of these teams are dead tied. They have both lost a singular time, and all it's going to take is one of these teams to lose again for a winner to be decided.
So welcome to Bracket Reset, and we hope you enjoy your stay here. We hope this match is exciting. Thanks to the 1,000+ people that have decided to join us again, the most we have seen since the first match we saw with SoCal in the tournament. So, or the first one we saw with Vaxxay in the tournament. So pleasure to be here with y'all. Hope you stick around for the Bracket Reset as we look back towards these two teams here, where Virginia has to kind of pull themselves together just a little bit here. They only were able to pick up 1 point, which of course is not what they're really going for here, but you know, SoCal did have a couple of maps that were rather close. Virginia could mix up their bans a little bit. Unfortunately, so can SoCal, and they could ban that one map that Virginia won. I imagine SoCal is probably going to ban out that HG3 with the low AR. They almost lost it, but maybe they'll stick to their guts. Maybe they'll keep the same bans. SoCal is one of those teams that plans things out ahead of time. They know exactly what they're doing when they come into a match. You know, with a bracket reset, SoCal hasn't had to go through this many times before. So, you know, there's not exactly too much to say about what they're going to change up here, but there is some room for improvement from both teams here. I think Virginia definitely, you know, the notable improvement they need is to grab a couple of more points. SoCal also some improvement needed on a couple maps that were very, very close that SoCal maybe didn't want to be as close. But you know, in the end, as I mentioned before, Virginia are definitely the ones here that need to kind of pull themselves together mentally and, you know, figure out their picks, because a couple of those definitely didn't go as either well as they expected them to, or were just complete mispicks, unfortunately. So hopefully we'll see a little bit of a difference here. The next match is going to be immediately when all the players are in the new lobby. They're probably going to go over a couple of their spreadsheets, grab some water, use the bathroom, anything that they need to do, wash their hands, whatever you do to relax yourself for a bracket reset in the grand finals. But they'll be prepared. They will return to us when it is time for the match to come back. So stay tuned for that.
And I think hopefully that break does wonders for Virginia, because I think they need it. It didn't go as well as it liked, huh?
Yeah, definitely not. I don't think you know, we've been talking about it the past couple of days, and I guess there's not really much to hide, but you know, who doesn't want an exciting grand finals match? And I guess the outcome that we just saw is kind of like our worst case scenario here, where we unfortunately are sitting here watching a team play the game. It kind of goes back to what OWC 2 years ago now, where it was the United States versus the UK, and I don't remember which commentator it was, but they said this is a match where you have four people on one side who are having the match of their lives, and they're playing, they're like the best at what they do. And on the other side of the screen, you have four guys you picked up off the street, handed a tablet, and said, good luck. That is a quote from OWC, and I feel like it really can't apply too much better to this match here. You have SoCal, the quote-unquote gods of this game, the players that you think of when you think of insane tournament performance and solo performance and consistency. And on Virginia, you have like the half-tournament players, the half-OWC players, the half, you know, super famous OSU streamers. Like, it's a good team. They're great players. They are, you know, consistent. They have high skill caps, but when you go up against SoCal, they have that high skill cap paired with the consistency, paired with the name, paired with the scariness of like a SoCal team. So it's definitely something you gotta look forward to.
Yeah. It's just a tricky spot to be in, I guess, is all it comes down to every time we say it. Like, SoCal has a couple of the best current players in history of the game. I think, you know, Vaxxay doesn't play
game
as, doesn't play as many tournaments as Bubble Man, who I think a lot of people consider kind of the greatest tournament player in the world. But Vaxxay at his peak has a higher skill cap. And Idhi, of course, has shown up to tournaments time and again. So, you know, if you're Virginia, it's good to be here. You know, I think everyone everyone at the start of this tournament saw this SoCal roster come in and they said, oh, well, you might as well give a badge now. Obviously, Ohio had other things to say about that in the winner's bracket, but the scaling of this SoCal team is just so utterly ridiculous. You can't outscale them. I mean, the only way to outscale them would be... What team would you even put together? I mean, you know, if you've got Idhi and Vaxxay together, like, that's going to scale as well as pretty much any other two players you pick in the world. You know, what are you going to do? Like, Bubbleman, Whitecat.
Yeah.
But, you know, you come into this grand final, and like you said, you know, the strategy can switch up a little bit, and I think that's what I think that's what I hope to see Virginia do a little bit in the second set here, is, you know, maybe you don't first pick Nomad 5 again, you know, for instance. You know, maybe you look at some of the more aim mechanics. Maybe you look at, like, a Nomad 1. You know, we'll see if SoCal bans Hard Rock 1 again. Otherwise, maybe you'll get that pick. You go for something a little different. You know, maybe you even, if Hidden 2 gets left up again, maybe you go Hidden 2 instead of Hidden 3. Or, you know, you go Hidden 3 again if they leave that up, and you hope that you improve by just that little bit that would be required to win. So, I think you try to stay unfazed by the fact that you just lost 7-1 to, you know, to this team, and you try to think, what can we do positively going forward to kind of improve on some of these picks and to kind of improve on some of our plays? And I don't know what necessarily to think that they'll do with their picks and bans. I don't know what to expect. I think you maybe change the ban a little bit. But, you know?
Yeah. You know, I guess they're just looking for warm-ups right now, so...
Yeah, apparently Virginia does want a warm-up, even though SoCal doesn't want one. So SoCal's going to skip their warm-up. We're going to go to Virginia for the only warm-up here. Hopefully it doesn't
Monko
crash the
would
planet.
Like to skip. Vaxxay says maybe.
South California is skipping theirs no matter what. It's just, I guess Virginia wants warm-ups for some reason, so they're gonna go
Toxicity.
They're gonna go Toxicity. Do I have this map? I think this map.
It loaded. Nope, didn't load for me. I in fact still have gas playing in the background.
Nope, I actually have this. I don't know why I have this in my tournament client folder. But I'm not complaining, because this song slaps. So we're going to see a warm-up here. And we're going to... sorry, apologies to any of you who are in the server, but you're getting another bracket reset and another ping. And we'll at here.
At here, bracket reset.
At here, bracket reset, starting now. So... We'll get back into this for the second set. And I guess we're still waiting on another player for Virginia here. I don't know who their third is going to be for this warm-up, but... they're changing it. Dang, I was so excited! Wait, maybe they're changing it. Wait, I don't know. Did they change it?
I would like to let you know, unfortunately, to chat, we will not be seeing Explosion Boom tonight. He is out... getting food at McDonald's right now.
Is that actually?
Yep. So, Explosion Boom, if anyone wants anything from McDonald's, let them know. Virginia be talking strategies while SoCal is talking about how dry chicken nuggets are in the U.S. Yeah.
Yo, those Minute Maid lemonade slushes sound high-key pretty solid, dude. Not gonna lie.
They are. They are very good. $2 each, by the way, so pick one up. This has been our sponsored ad for McDonald's.
Sponsored
Thank
stream
you.
By McDonald's.
Much appreciated at McDonald's USA.
I would like a quarter pounder with cheese, medium fries, and a lemonade slush. you.
Yeah, this will be that'll be fun. T1G, when are we going to McDonald's together?
Listen, you either have to come to Michigan or I have to go to Massachusetts, and I'm not really sure which of those is the preferable option.
Yeah, you got a point. We'll figure it out eventually. We'll meet in the middle in Ohio.
No, please. Can we meet in the middle in Pennsylvania instead?
Pennsylvania is definitely not in the middle.
Can we meet in Pittsburgh?
Like New York or something?
I guess it depends on like whether are we thinking like as the crow flies or like within the continental U.S. because that really kind of changes up the definition of where the middle is.
Oh, true.
New Jersey? How is New Jersey in the middle? Explain to me how New Jersey would be in the middle.
New Jersey's not in the middle. I mean, New Jersey is about in the middle as Pennsylvania is. We're just gonna meet dead in the we're gonna meet dead in the middle of the world in Egypt. Yeah. No, we're gonna meet in the middle of the United States, the middle of the continental United States, in like Nebraska.
I can't tell if this is off sync. I think it's off sync because I probably would have to re-download this because it probably got updated, but it's like close enough. The emphasis in this is really weird. I guess it's fine.
Yeah, that would be good. We can go to McDonald's in the UK when they stop not wanting
us there. When the United States stops being idiots about this freaking pandemic shit and other countries realize that we're not dumbasses, but I don't know that that's likely to happen anytime soon because we're continuing to be dumbasses.
Yay! What a fun time. There is a...
It's a great time to be alive.
For those of you that don't know, in New England, if you're in Massachusetts, there is like a whole... quarantine zone, I guess, where if you travel out of Massachusetts to certain states in New England, you cannot like come back and work and stuff without getting COVID tested or quarantining for 14 days. And Rhode Island is the only state in New England that you are not allowed to come back from and work immediately. You have to get tested.
Rhode Island, of all places.
No Brazilians in my marriage. Chez bananas. Come on, Chez.
Can we talk about the fact that Vax is still assessing, by the way? And, yeah, and Monko has like a 1x100.
Yeah,
and Chrono is FCing with Hidden.
Yeah. Chrono 5 should just unironically play every map that one Tabby played.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, like, Virginia's got to change things up if they want to have a shot here. Might as well, you know, change some picks, change some rosters, see what happens. Because, I mean, worst case scenario, you lose, which you did before anyway, so, I mean, you might as well throw stuff at the wall and see if it sticks.
Yeah, look at it this way, though. If we know SoCal doesn't have Explosion Boom, that's one of their carries gone. So,
yeah, just
we have...
Just pick the Explosion Boom maps.
Yeah. So pick the Explosion Boom, like, stream aim.
That's
and then...
Pick hidden, pick Nomad 2?
Yeah, Nomad 2.
Oh, Vax, they missed. No!
Oh, Chrono 5 missed as well.
Meanwhile, Tony and Monko still going strong here, and Itki just a bit behind.
Yeah, Tony's having a good time on this Monko. Definitely the accuracy with 99.58.
It's interesting that Vax was single-tapping... Benurim earlier, but he's alternating this. I find that fascinating for some reason.
Yeah, this is
like he's perfect alternating this, but he single tapped Lindworm.
You know what? Vaxxay can essentially
Monko
just
and
oh,
Tony
there goes Tony
just died. Vaxxay was the only person to hit that pattern.
He's really just proving to us that he can do anything he wants whenever he wants.
He literally just does not care. He simply does not care.
Vaxxay will wake up the morning of a tournament match and he'll have single tap the entire map the entire time he's ever practiced it, and he'll wake up the morning of the match and be like, I will alternate today, and then just do it. He's hitting all of
God,
this,
God, his aim is just mesmerizing to watch, honestly.
It's the middle ground between snappy and flow aim.
It's just it's
and
so
it's insane.
I hate commentating this because it just makes me sound like a Vaxxay fanboy. But he's just so much better than everyone else. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, that was impressive. Chrono 5 though, almost 1,000 combo on hidden, actually beating Vaxxay's combo. Haha. Chrono 5 beat Vaxxay's combo.
Tony and Monko both beat Vaxxay's combo as well. It's just his one miss 99.3 ack.
Yeah, but I'm going to focus on Kron because he's the man.
Yeah, honestly, Kron is a pretty good player.
He's a very good player. I think we should see more of Kron in this match. Chrono 5 actually I don't know how many of you know what match costs are. Chrono 5 actually top match costed for Virginia.
He played one map.
Not bracket
he
reset.
One map.
You know what? Nobody will ever know that unless they click on the MP link. But Chrono 5, 1.54 match cost compared to Rectigon, 1.5.
All right, so it's interesting. We're already seeing the bans coming out. We saw SoCal winning the role once again.
No one two
ban again. So their first ban in everything. I don't get it, but okay. I mean, I guess I get it.
It makes sense. It makes sense after last week because the one time they didn't ban it, they lost Nomad 2. So they're scared now.
Yeah, right. They left it up against Ohio. Both times they played Ohio, and the second time Ohio won it. I don't think they played it the first time, right? All right. Well, be that as it may, we're going to see if Virginia decides to switch up the ban strategy at all. I don't know. They banned Nomad 3, Freemod 3 in that order, and they're banning Freemod 3 first this time, so they're switching that up at least.
Yeah, very interesting.
I wonder if they're going to wait and see what SoCal second bans this time.
Yeah, I think it's almost what we talked about earlier, where SoCal is probably going to stick to their guts and ban the same maps, and there it is, so there's Hard Rock 1. So SoCal did exactly what we mentioned. They ban exactly the same stuff because they know what they need to do in this match. I think I did mention it and entertain the idea that SoCal might just ban the map that Virginia won. But then again, you know, why would they worry about one map?
And considering how Virginia. Close that given map was, it was literally, 7,000 points? And it was because of where Vaxay's miss was? So, definitely. I don't think they feel that bad about losing that one pick this time.
It's one of those things where you really don't you don't have to change much when you're SoCal because you have the mental of the win and you're in the bracket reset and you're basically just waiting for Virginia to pick into you on half of these maps because I don't know if there's enough in this pool that Virginia has, you know, like that guaranteed FC on that we always talk about for SoCal. You know, Virginia does end up banning Nomad 3 again, so I guess they do kind of keep the same for both teams, essentially. But the only difference being that Freemod 3 there.
It's just the order of the bans. Definitely. That's the only thing that changed.
Yeah.
And now that being said, we're not going to... I would put about a 0.1% chance we see Nomad 5 first pick again. They are going to, I think, switch up their pick order.
Yeah, that would be smarter for them. And I don't know... SoCal is also one of those teams that doesn't have to care so much that they could switch up their pick order to whatever they want and it would still be fine for them. But...
Yeah, I mean, I think, if I'm SoCal in this bracket reset, I'm going to, first pick DT2, second pick DT3, and just be like, you know what? We're the DT dominant team in every match we've played, and we're going to keep that up. That would be, I think, don't bother with this Freemod first pick trying to be cute crap. Just blast the DT again. So Virginia picking Nomad a map that did not get played at all in the last set. It is going to be the Nomad 1 first pick. So get your alerts out in chat. It is Nomad 1. And it is a new pick as the first map of the bracket reset here.
Very cool to see something that we didn't see, even if it is a Nomad 1. And this is actually probably a decent pick for Virginia with BTMC, Tony, and Rectigon. You know, I know we talk about that like core three a lot in these maps. This is a very, very good aim three versus another very good aim three. Nomad 1, for those of you that are asking, there's not much special about them, and that's why everyone freaks out, because when you pick it, it is the most RNG thing you could possibly go for unless you have the three best aim players in the game. So against SoCal, I guess this is a decent pick for Virginia on the basis that, you know, SoCal can just miss. It looks like they will be putting headstack in for the Nomad 1. I'm pretty sure this is the only thing Headstack has played past the first round for SoCal. But this is one of those maps where you will lose because you just miss on jumps, and that's how jumps work. So I guess Virginia is going to kind of leave it up to RNG here and their consistency on aim today to bring them through the first pick.
And this one, I think, is a little bit more of a tricky Nomad 1. There are some slightly awkward patterns, a little bit of one-third rhythms here and there. So you know, it's not just like a straight up 1-2 jump map. And, you know, we have historically, I feel, seen a lot of top teams kind of shy away from Nomad 1s because they do introduce that aspect of RNG feeling for them, I think, there, where if you miss in the middle of one jump section in the middle of the map, well, all of a sudden your score is like 600k. As Ed finds the first break here for Virginia. So top teams,
slider break.
Yeah, top teams who want to rely on their skill cap, typically Nomad 1 and just those generic game maps in general are kind of the maps that they don't want to have show up. So we do see a break from Headstack though as well. That'll be helping Virginia's cause out, and you just see like Vaxay and Idki FCing the aim and wrecking on with the early break. Headstack is broken twice, Idki breaking as well, so it is now Vaxay versus Tony. With a pretty solid accuracy advantage on Vaxay, but the score gap is going to stay very close between the two teams for the time being.
Yeah, this is essentially, the accuracy gap is massive, but what we're also not mentioning is Tony completely missed the first pattern, which is why his ACK is lower.
Yeah, he just didn't play the first seven notes of the map or something.
Yeah, he did not have a good time at the beginning of this map, so he is basically down on that alone. I think his 100 count is lower than Vaxay's, or the same. It's basically just the misses on him. BTMC had an early break, but he's got a good combo going for him now. If he's able to hold combo with Tony for the rest of the map, this is going to stay on the side of Virginia because, you know, Rektigan is matching the combo of either Vaxay 2, Idki, or Headstack. And BTMC's got about double the combo of the next best player, and Tony's holding off Vaxay with all he can right now.
Oh, and there's the break BTMC from Ed and Tony. Oh, boy.
Ooh, that's,
this
right,
just
that
got
all went
bad
very fast
for Virginia. And that's halfway through the map. It is the worst possible place to miss. And Vaxay, Idki, and Headstack all with pretty solid combos. Now it's just Rektigan for Virginia. Vaxay finding a break. There goes that FC.
He just misread that. Vaxay's cursor just went everywhere except for the jump that it needed to be on because he misread worse than I've ever seen him misread before.
Fortunately for him, it just doesn't matter because Tony and then Rektigan both broke, and Headstack is actually holding a very impressive 675 combo. That's going to keep SoCal more than comfortably in the lead as Ed finds another break. Virginia not having a good time of things here.
Yeah, I'm not really too surprised about this. Headstack is like the resident Nomad 1 player for SoCal. The only reason he's not scoring over Vaxay or Idki is purely because of their skill caps and that break at the beginning. But, you know, he's essentially like the one player on their team that can keep up with Vaxay and Idki on Nomad 1s here. And, you know, for Virginia, they're just having a rough time with some of these big jumps here and a lot of people missing that stream section.
Oh my, everyone just broke.
Wow.
Well, fortunately, we're at the point in the map where nobody having combo means that it's kind of just going to end because
especially with BTMC's slider breaking.
Yeah, I mean, it's 150k score gap. SoCal is just going to bring this one home, and that's kind of the essence of a Nomad 1. You can just miss in any sort of place, and this one being pretty tricky with the space patterns means that you can break even more than normal.
Yeah, and a lot of people.
This is a SoCal win. 200k.
Yeah, one Rektigan kind of just giving up on the slider.
Rektigan's
at the
done.
End.
Wait, what was he writing?
Yeah,
I said D, and that was it.
I kind of want to go to his stream to see what he was writing, but at the same time, you know, Virginia is in the place after the bracket reset, and you know, to be honest, Virginia was kind of in this place before the match. You don't go into a match against SoCal, at least anyone that I know. You don't go into a match against SoCal with the idea in your head that you are going to win the match or that you have like a very good shot of taking a ton of points against SoCal. I think Virginia was unfortunately in a little bit of a weird spot before the match. And even if their mental wasn't awful going into that or even going into this bracket reset, it's definitely hard to keep the... There's almost like this external motivation that you give off as a player when you're going through where it's you got the hype around the different maps and the picks and the excitement of starting a different one and seeing what's going to happen versus you and the other team. And, you know, like, am I going to FC this? Am I going to, you know, completely die or something on this pick? It's that external motivation and emotion that you show versus, you know, that subtle interior part that you don't really show to the rest of your team where it's like, maybe on the outside when you're talking to your team and VC and you're discussing the picks and everything, you seem perfectly fine, but like, you know, deep down in the back of your mind, you're thinking to yourself, like, what are my chances of winning this? Like, is this a lost cause? Is everything I'm doing right now something just completely useless against this team that is inevitably the best team in the tournament for a reason? So, you know, Virginia's really got to find a comfortable spot here if they want to bring this back early. They did trade picks back and forth on the first run through of this map. So let's see if Virginia is able to take SoCal's pick on this one undressed as goblins. This score was pretty close on this map, so I feel like it does still have the opportunity to go both ways. But this is definitely one of those maps where, you know, your excitement lies around whoever's getting the ridiculous combo through like that end section. And other than that, you're either just missing everywhere or hitting it. And we saw Tony have a rough time on this map before, and hopefully he's able to pull himself together on this one. Ed put up a very good score for his team with that slider break. So Virginia has full opportunity to take a point on this. Tony not starting off too strong again, but there is plenty of opportunity left in the map here.
Yeah, and I think there's a couple of things that we're going to be looking out for this time around on this map, right? You saw Rectigon with the 746k Hard Rock 4 miss 1300 combo last time. Can he replicate that? That's going to be a big question because they only won this by 7,000 points, so it was every bit of that combo that he put up required to win this pick. Tony with a decent hidden score, not great. You had Ed with the slider break S rank. You had Vaxay with a one miss at a not great time, right? And so he can come out and just FC this time because he's one missed it both previous times he's played it. And you've got Monko who continues to struggle a little bit with this map. Not his strongest pick. And Ibki didn't play this as well as he could have last time around. So a few different question marks. You know, this is the interesting thing when you get into a bracket reset and you play the same map again, as we see Ed finding that early break as well again. You can judge against the previous set and kind of have some expectations, but also be able to say this is where they can both improve or this is where they can lose some points. And so yeah, far, we're seeing much the same thing as last time around, where Rectigon is holding a big combo early on, but this time Idki's doing better and Vaxay is still holding onto his FC. So SoCal out to the early lead, as once again, Tony and Monko just not having a great time. This is so tough with hidden on some of these patterns. You miss one note and you just miss the entire thing.
Yeah, the big difference on this right now is Vaxay's performance compared to the last time through. BTMC did find the same break that he did on the first time, so as long as he does FC the rest of the map here, he's going to be fine score comparatively, and he's slider break, so Ed is actually going to do worse, unfortunately, and Vaxay is doing better than he did before. Yeah. Idki dropped a ton of hundreds there, but it doesn't really matter on Hard Rock. His accuracy is about the same as Rectigon.
Yeah, Idki's 1% higher accuracy than Rectigon, both Hard Rock, both still holding the FC, and Vaxay, as always, is just the X factor for SoCal here, coming in with another huge performance on this map. I mean, like I said, he's played this twice, he's missed twice, and it was on that pattern the first time around, so I think he's just gonna FC this time. And you know, the Idki versus Rectigon Hard Rock battle here is continuing onward, but as long as Vaxay keeps that FC, it just doesn't matter. As long as those two continue to match each other, Vaxay is gonna be more than enough to carry this for SoCal, especially with Tony really struggling a lot.
Kind of a free combo section here for these players as well. Oh, Rectigon breaks on nothing.
Rectigon and Tony both broke on nothing, and that's a tilter. That's what that is.
That Rectigon could be like such a good play.
That could be match ending. Like, your mental after breaking there on a map that you won last time that you were still in the thick of this time. Oh man, that's tough.
They're almost FCing too. This is like barely to the end of the map here. If Rectigon hits the entire rest of this, I imagine he's not going to be too happy about that break. It wouldn't have won them the map, but just the thought of knowing you could have and missed it by just that much.
SoCal is a cheat code. They just double FC'd that. Oh, excuse me. Idki missed at the very end. They almost double FC'd that. Vaxay did FC, so I you know, good bit of a profit there.
Rectigon slider break.
Rectigon with the slider break
though.
S rank. Man, he improved his score. He did everything he needed to do, and it just wasn't enough. I mean, because you're against SoCal, and it's just never enough against SoCal. I mean, SoCal just improved their score by 500,000 points. Like, not 500, 900,000 points. Let me see here. What was their score?
Vaxay FC'd and Idki basically FC'd.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's not fair.
They had two players that did not FC the first time around, basically FC the second time around. There's really just
not much you could have gotten.
No, I... And what's interesting is Virginia actually beat their score from last time by 4,000 points. Like, they put up almost an identical score to the first time, which was enough to win the first time around. And SoCal just said, oh, right, we're South California, and they won it by 715K. Like, what do you do? What do you do? I don't know.
You're back to Hard Rock 2.
You go back to Hard Rock 2, and I don't know why. Quite honestly, I don't know why.
You know, to be perfectly honest, this is actually a really good pick for Virginia. I mentioned it when they played this map the first time around in the original, you know, Grand Finals match. But that beginning triangle pattern, the super dense one, I was very surprised to actually see Tony miss there. He did break along with him, but BTMC and Rectigun both held combos along with Vaxxay and Monko. And it really came down to when that break happened. I mentioned that, you know, one difference in that beginning break from either team could have given up the score difference, because this map was a really close pick, and it really was going to come down to that one player not missing. You know, BTMC held for almost the entire map last time, if you remember. You almost FC'd. And it really, this pick, I think for Virginia, this is like the little bit of RNG they're looking for that we keep mentioning, where it's, you know, does Tony hit that opening pattern and does Idki miss it again? I wonder if they're just going on the fact that Tony might be confident that he's able to hit it this time after seeing it once in a match. And he's just going to hope that his teammates are able to put up similar scores. And I think Virginia has a chance of grabbing this.
There is a chance, and I mean, there's always a chance. Strictly speaking, there's always a chance. I mean, once again though, it's like just the question that SoCal will maybe answer again. Like, Vaxxay won this last time, you know. Everybody get the thing this time. So there is some benefit to having played the map like an hour ago. You are a little more comfortable with it potentially, but it's still SoCal accuracy advantage this time instead of any combo advantage. But, you know, Vaxxay 1-miss, Monko 4-miss, Idki 2-miss. Like, there's always room for improvement if you didn't 3-way it, right? And that's the kind of thing SoCal makes you pay for, is they just improve their scores. But Virginia can improve this as well. They have all 6 players. No, I tell a lie. Idki found a break that I completely was blind to.
Yeah, I didn't see that as well. So Virginia's actually got a good advantage here. Idki broke it. Not an amazing
break.
Idki breaks again.
Idki breaks again, so combo is pretty much even. It's going to be on Ed and Tony here to hold these FCs in the last quarter of the map. Oh, and there goes Monko.
Monko, this is going to be Virginia's point. But there goes Idki and BTMC breaks it. It's Vaxxay versus Tony.
Vaxxay versus Tony, and they could just double FC this, and it could be... And Virginia... Oh,
Tony breaks!
There they go. Virginia's gone, and Vaxxay is still holding, and it's just going to be enough because Vaxxay is going to do the thing.
Vaxxay. All right, Vaxxay, stop pissing me off, damn it.
Give them a chance, please. Please give them a chance.
Can you make Explosion Boom play from his phone at, like, McDonald's,
like,
or something?
It was so close, and then Virginia just wiped, and Vaxxay said, oh, right, IFC this map, and SoCal won another point.
We say it continuously. How many
every
states
map.
Beat that?
How often is he going to do this? Like, every single map, it seems like that's just the thing that's happening. Like, Virginia looks like they're going to have a chance. They keep it close for a long way through, and then they miss, and SoCal says, okay, bye.
We said this in the first match. Virginia is putting up insane scores on these maps, but they are against SoCal, who just double S-ranked Polygon with Hard Rock, which is something that maybe 2% of players can even dream of doing in this, and they're going to go back to Gold Dust because you're SoCal, and you can have 2 players FC this map, and why wouldn't you? Because Virginia basically only had Ed hold combo for the majority of this map. Yes, this is considered
bullying.
Yes,
this is considered bullying. This is genuinely bullying. I mean, that is from the players themselves. I mean, this is just bullying. It's like... Vaxxay comes in and just says, we're playing this map, and he FCs it, and Idki and Monko put up solid scores behind him. I mean, they both put up, Monko put up 761K, like, that's a damn good score in its own right, and it just gets overshadowed by the fact that Vaxxay FC'd. And now they're going to come in and, you know, like, put up some more ridiculous scores, because they can all play this map really well.
Yeah, this is... For those of you that are in the USC server, maybe check general. I think Dada kind of hit the nail on the head with that. But, you know, as of right now,
Monko finds an early break along with Tony like last time, and what this could come down to maybe is Rectigan not finding the breaks that he did, but you know,
yeah,
there,
yeah,
it's
okay.
This.
You had to say it. You just had to say it. Oh, that's
it's
unfortunate.
Ed. It's Ed again.
Oh,
basically.
But did he with a break to match it?
It's Ed versus Vaxxay 1v1 again, and Ed breaks earlier than he did.
Ed breaks this time earlier. That being said, Tony is still holding a pretty solid combo, but it would require Vaxxay and Monko to both break, because once again, Monko just puts up good combos on this map. Like, he's really good at this kind of stuff.
Monko currently break.
So, just the very beginning break, but he's matching combos with Tony.
Vaxxay
Vaxxay with the break!
Wait, that's very big. That's very big. If Monko still holds his combo and nobody else does on SoCal, this can go to Virginia on a combo advantage on Rectigan and Tony. BTMC is backing them up with a higher combo than Vaxxay on a matching Idkeys, but it's going to be Vaxxay
breaking
again.
Again.
What's happening? He heard us. He heard us.
Oh, and Malcolm breaks as well. This is going to go over to Virginia. They're going to take the lead here regardless of that break from Ed. But Rectigan breaks too. Never mind. It's going to be a little slower. Tony's got to hold on. And it's going to flicker over. If Tony holds on, they can do this.
He's got the accuracy, and it was all down to Tony on the last Hard Rock map, and let's see if he can redeem himself from breaking at the end of this one. He's got the score lead in the favor of Virginia, and we come into the last stream here. He's shaking so bad.
It's more breaks from Virginia, though. Ed and Rectigan keep breaking, and Tony and Inky both break. It's going to be SoCal, because Monko and Vaxxay have gotten their combo just a little bit back together into the ending, and once again, SoCal takes a point that was just so close for Virginia, just right there, and they couldn't quite do it. And I mean, that is a hell of a play from Tony. Like, all the credit in the world, 970k just breaking near the ending there, but Monko and Vaxxay with those big combos in the end after Idki broke, enough to maintain that lead for SoCal, and that's 4-0 lead now. I mean, what do you do? It's just those little breaks right here and there, and it just swings, it turns the tide.
Tony, unfortunately, shaking at the end there. You know, dare I say, BTMC had a really good play on this the first time around, which kind of surprised me, because this was not something, even with all of Ed's 10.3 practice, you know, he's made massive improvements and everything, but it was a score that was almost like weird for Ed. Like, the combo was really good this time as well, but it was something that, like, it was almost questionable whether or not he was going to be able to replicate something like that. And I guess, you know, maybe it was just that little bit that he needed, and maybe it's the nervousness of the bracket reset even, but any factor that would just prevent him from putting up the same combo. Unfortunately, you know, Tony improved his score massively, and you know, if Tony put up that score in the first round through of this, Virginia may have come close to winning that. But you know, it's down to SoCal just having that DT prowess that no other team can match. And you know, when you go to HD1 on Mold, you know, this is, I feel like, Virginia's last stand here.
Boy, I don't know about this pick. We'll see what happens with it. I mean, I don't know that Virginia has the lineup to stand up to SoCal on this. Rectigan, not as strong and hidden as he is on Hard Rock. Same for Ed. Tony can play this pretty well, I'm sure, but I mean, Vaxxay one miss with like insane accuracy at 1300 combo on this yesterday, and that was just the big difference maker, because nobody else even came close to that score. So we'll see again. I mean, I feel like I keep saying that. It's just kind of it's got to be played out. We've got to see what happens, but it's,
there goes Idki.
There goes Idki. Maybe
yeah,
this...
but you know what? We've said that on 7 maps in a row now. There goes Idki,
yeah,
and then
right,
Idki like... FDs the rest of the map. Oh, but now Idki's dying. Okay,
Idki did really pretty poorly on this yesterday. I mean, he got 350k on this yesterday, so not his map. You know, they just let Vaxxay carry, and it might be the case here again today, but Virginia holding on to the three-way full combo still. They are going to take a pretty big early lead. I mean, it's already 60,000 points just into the first Ki here. So as long as they can maintain their full combos through this chorus, they'll be in a decent spot going forward. This is impressive stuff.
Oh, Tony!
Ooh, the first to break.
Right.
Oh, and there
and
goes Ed with the slider break.
Oh, there goes Virginia.
And
well,
there goes...
see you later, everyone.
Rectigan's still holding on against Vaxxay and Monko. If either of them finds a break, that'll be okay for Virginia, but the score gap is going to shrink very quickly. It's going to go over to SoCal here pretty rapidly at this juncture of the map as Ed completely misread, that pattern.
And there goes Rektagon as well, but there goes Manco and Idki is now holding combo and it's backstay with 99%
accuracy. Can we just ignore that top square on the right-hand side of the screen? Can that just not exist, please?
If we subtracted 280,000 from South California, they would in fact be losing. But Vaxxay has 99% accuracy, and Tony misses again. And BTMC is the highest combo on Virginia, which is, in fact, four times less than the highest combo on SoCal. Welcome to United States Cup. Idki finally breaks on the linear stream, but Vaxxay is now at 99.41 FCing Mold with Hidden. This is a play that you see all the time from Vaxxay, but once in a blue moon outside of this match.
We've seen this 2 days in a row from him now. Does drop some of the accuracy. He'll end up probably lower accuracy than he did yesterday, regardless of what happens. But this is just a casual play for him, whereas for anyone else, like, this would be play of the lifetime for most players. That being said, Virginia has a lot of combo here. If Vaxxay breaks, Manco breaks, like, there's actually time. So this is still winnable. Not going to say it's over until it's over. Tony, a break. Ed and Rektagon have big combos, but we're coming into this last chorus here, and the SoCal train showing no signs of stopping. Idki does find another break, but that's not really all that important.
And yeah, they really need all three. There goes BTMC as well. It's basically lost, unfortunately. For those of you that don't know as well, this is a spider on the wind diff of Mold.
Yeah, this is the top diff.
This is the top diff, and there is not a single mod FC on this. Vaxxay's gonna do it 2 days in a row.
What if he one missed this at 1300? Like, he has now passed his combo by 100.
He missed stream. Oh.
Yeah, you hate to see it. So not gonna be an FC either time for Vaxxay, but he's gonna put up two really insane scores on this yesterday and today. Rektagon with a very respectable performance over on the Virginia side does find that break near the end, but 635k is not a score to sneeze at. 634k. But again, it's just SoCal able to rely on the fact that Vaxxay is going to come in and put up 880,000 points with a one miss. Again, he's played this map twice, and he missed twice on it. You just hate to see it.
Unfortunately for Virginia, they did kind of lose player for player, which, you know, is, I guess, better if you're looking back on it. Like, you probably didn't really have a chance on this with, you know, BTMC being below Manco and Tony scoring just below Idki and Rektagon. You know, he was the closest to Vaxxay, but still a long shot from the rest of them here. So, you know, Vaxxay can everything. Like, this is one of those matches where, like Game Osu this past year, Vaxxay just decides to show up with the force of 1,000 men in a tournament match and lay down the law. And now that Lindworm is coming out, which is another Vaxxay map, you know, this is really down to, you know, Vaxxay pulling out literally everything he possibly can to end this as fast as he can.
So, does Vaxxay FC this time, you think?
I think he comes close. I don't know if he FCs.
He 3-missed with 1-100 and 150 in the previous set. He also set a rank 2 score on this map on Bancho before the match, with like 99.81% no mod FC, something like that. So, you know, this is SoCal just kind of flexing. And I mean, from a competitive standpoint, it kind of sucks, but hey, man, at least we're getting to see some of the best players in the game, or one of the best players in the game, and at his absolute near... I mean, I'm never going to say peak, because he's had so many incredible moments, but this is Vaxxay playing like Vaxxay, and it's fun to watch.
This is not fun to watch. I am not having fun.
Vaxxay's fun to watch. Let's be real here. You got to at least enjoy watching his view, if nothing else.
True, but... this is...
and everyone dies in the intro. This map is so hard for, like, everyone, and then Vaxxay just casually says,
BTMC.
Ed is holding on with 89 ACK, but, you know, he's keeping the combo alive.
He's there. The combo is really all that... oh, never mind. See you on the square.
All right, well...
See Manco on the square as well, actually.
Yeah, SoCal going to take another pretty big early lead. There's combo being put together here by pretty much all players after you get through that intro, which is very, very hard. things quiet down just a tad, but then they come right back at you with those triangles, and One Tabby and Tony both finding some breaks. Man, Ed, dude, like, he's hitting stuff.
Such a good time.
He's hitting stuff. Like, I am so proud of Ed for the improvement that he's made as a tournament player. He's coming in and he's hitting stuff. Yeah, he's missing it here and there, and yeah, he's not, you know, he can't match Vaxxay, but dude has improved so much, and he's playing pretty well in this match, all things considered. But Vaxxay, 99.7 ACK, single tapping, FC still alive, and that's into the last third here.
That's
as,
not okay.
As
everyone breaks.
Monko, excuse me, and Matthew. I'm so used to just being the same three people. Monko and Matthew find some breaks. Tony actually with some pretty solid combo as well as Beast Troll MC. But
Vaxxay hit what he broke on last time.
Vaxxay hit the thing he broke on last time, and so that's going to just be that. It, you know, he's like, it's like a robot where you have to teach it, and it learns, like, then the second time around, it just does it flawlessly. I don't know. It's scary. It's really terrifying, the fact that he's about to hit FC. This would be, this without his play that he did an hour and a half ago, that would have been rank 2 on Banjo, and this is, that would have been rank 3 on Banjo. And that's 6-0. It's match point. It's championship point. It's Vaxxay, FC, everything. I don't know what to say anymore, because the man is just too good at Osu.
This was not okay. This was not a fun play. That was 3 100s on Lindworm, which is a feat in itself. When you add in the fact that he just single tapped that, it makes it even more impressive. That is quite literally a play for the ages. I dare, like, literally dare I say that is quite literally the best play in this tournament.
I would have to agree. That's probably the best play we've seen in this entire tournament.
Vaxxay just improved his personal best accuracy by 1x100, by the way, that he set 3 hours ago.
This was better ACK than that? I must have misread. I thought it was 99.81 on the Banjo play. I must have been mistaken.
His play is 99.61 3 hours ago, okay, with 4 100s. He just got 3 100s.
So that would be rank 2 on Banjo.
only person ever to full combo this map with max combo. Choco Mint, obviously, Hidden Hard Rock, what the hell?
Yeah, Shige,
921.
Shige's like ludicrously good at maps like that. I mean, that was his specialty for so long. Was just FCing shit with HDHR that nobody could FC Nomad for a very long time. That score is 3 years old, by the way, and it still hasn't been beaten. That score is from March of 2017. So shout outs to Cookiezy for being a ludicrously good Osu player. But Vaxxay now just showing off in front of our eyes here in this match.
There is a chance. There is a chance if Virginia wins all 6 of the next picks, they could win in tiebreaker on Uta. This is theoretically possible. In some world, that is maybe not this one, but we can believe because that's what we do. I'm trying to sound confident in what I'm saying right now. Yes. Shout out to Matthew and Explosion Boom, who will also be getting the badge, even though you haven't really seen much of them, as well as Headstack. They are, in fact, on this team. It is not just Vaxxay, Idki, and Monko. There are, in fact, 3 other players on this team, like every other team. You just don't see them because they have been locked in the closet.
they're like actually tied to the bench. They get released for like the low AR. If there's something that Idki or Monko doesn't feel comfortable on.
Yeah, that's basically it. I mean, they're like the 3, you know, pit bulls you have on the chain leashes, and you just kind of let one of them go for a map, and then they go out, they do well on it, they give SoCal the point, and then they go back. SoCal, that's basically it. They have 3 carry players, and they're talking about some fun stuff in here.
Yeah, I gotta sort this out. I honestly, like, man,
they want to pick TB.
No,
they cannot do that.
Honestly, like, I'm not gonna, like, being 10 seconds late on a freaking pick timer when it's 6-0 in the grand finals, like, I'm just not that worried about it.
This is, I would like to personally welcome everyone back to OWC 2019. It's been a lovely break of a couple of months between this and, you know, fun to see you again.
They picked Hidden 3, and I guess they were like 10 seconds late on the timer, but it's like, if SoCal's okay with it, it's just, it's fine, because it's, at this point in the match, yeah. I'm not gonna go rules lawyer in a match that's like this one-sided.
Basically, yeah. Let Chrono 5 play his last map.
Yeah, let Kron come in, man. And
let Kron top match cost again.
Let's just have an enjoyable time here with the lads.
I'm not going to lie. I'm having a good time. I think this is a fantastic song. This is one of my favorite songs in this pool, so I am very happy about this. I think this is a great song. You know, all things aside, thank you, Dada, for putting good songs in the pool, at least. Like, all criticisms aside. I am fully allowing this chat spam. I will not stop any of you.
Alright. Chat spam Chrono 5. Let's go, dude. Chrono 5 back
love
in. Okay, this time he's going to FC. This time he is going to FC. Let's
Don't
go.
Don't say it. Don't say
no,
it.
No, no. This is the anti-curse. This is the anti-curse. This is the Chrono 5 anti-curse.
You're going to solo commentate this map because I'm not going to say anything to curse. Enjoy.
All right, man. Listen.
Nope, early nope, break from not, Matthew.
So the question is, will Vax AFC the intro this time? Because both times they play this, he's messed up in the intro pretty badly. And like, Inki and Matthew both breaking already.
I mean, Vax has also not FC'd maps and has now FC'd maps, so.
All right, so it's three FCs here for Virginia. Who's hype? Let's go, Virginia. Kron, One Tabby, and Tony gonna get a point on the board here for Virginia in this bracket reset match. I believe in these guys. They are some good dudes, and they deserve to at least get a point on the board. That is all. That's all I ask for. I feel for them because this is such a rough spot to be in, and I think any of us who have been in any competitive endeavor have been there, where you're just up against an overwhelmingly superior opponent.
Oh, there goes both of Kron's teammates.
And there go both One Tabby and Tony. But Matthew broke as well. However, Vaxe is still holding on. As is Inki, who did not break earlier, a little banjo. But Kron's still holding on,
come
man.
On,
let's go. Let's go,
on,
Kron.
Man.
Oh, and Vaxe broke.
Hit the wide angle. Hit the wide angle.
Kron hit the wide angle, and Vaxe broke.
Don't say anything. Don't say anything. Right. It is Inki.
Inki is comboing, and Matthew is comboing,
Inki.
And it is going over
Inki
to Virginia.
Comboing.
Oh, this is going to be so close. There's a third of the map to go. This is going to be so. Oh, what?
What? Kron! Oh my god, no!
You hate to see it, and now SoCal's just gonna win because Inki's gonna NFC.
Oh, there goes on the. Yeah, there he goes on the
loop
goes stream.
Virginia.
Inki's gonna do Inki things right now. Good game, well played.
In the immortal words of Dave Grohl, there goes my hero. Watch him as he goes. Kron, I love you. I wish you all the best in life, but SoCal is just too good.
You really...
You hate to see it. It's a mind-block map.
You know what? All things aside, Virginia is a really good team. Virginia has put up an insane performance. They have put up, what, 500k average for a three-person team in grand finals on several maps or higher. They have done amazingly for themselves. They should be as high as they possibly could be right now, even though they lost. This is, I know it's hard, but it's really one of those things where you cannot feel that down about this, really. It is just, you can't control it at a certain point. It is, you know, such... You know, a rough time. I would personally like to send some love over to Beastroll MC's stream right now. He's having a rough time with this.
I mean, yeah, it's...
You know what?
He went offline.
I will personally commend everybody on Virginia. Right. You know what? I really wish Ed rewatches this stream, I'll do it personally. I'm gonna make a compilation. I want to take every single nice thing I've possibly said about Ed and T1G has said about Ed in this stream. This was absolutely his showing up in tournaments this year. This was the best performance I've ever seen out of him. This is absolutely insane. He made the most improvement of any player I've seen in the past year. I don't care about any other tournament player that I've seen in the past year. He exactly did what he needed to do. He was everything for Virginia this year on so many freaking maps, and I absolutely loved seeing everyone in this tournament, including him, especially him in this tournament this year. We can congratulate SoCal all we want later. They had a good match, but like I'm giving serious commendations to Virginia right now because I think we focused a lot on SoCal in the match. Virginia showed, excuse my language, Virginia showed the fuck up for this match. Really, they made it all the way through this tournament. They made it to grand finals in the freaking winner's bracket, and they only lost because SoCal showed up and did exactly what they were probably going to do. I feel like I've said enough at this point, but you know, there's really not enough that can be said for the performance we've seen today.
Yeah, I completely agree. I mean, you know, there's always going to be a winner and a loser and all that, you know, BS that we talk about in sports, but Virginia showed just some absolutely ridiculous improvement over the past year. I mean, if there was ever a team that we were going to give the most improved award to, getting to the grand finals from the winner's bracket for the team Virginia, I think it has to go to them. All of their players performed incredibly well, and they just ran into this unstoppable juggernaut that is South California, who nobody was ever going to beat once it got to a late round. Yes, Ohio beat them in the semifinals, but the pools, as they scale up, SoCal just gets better. Virginia comes in, they take care of business in round of 16, quarterfinals, semifinals, and the winner's final, taking down Ohio in the winner's final in really impressive fashion. Like, I think it's easy to forget just how good Virginia is capable of looking, and honestly, how good they even look today, despite the loss. So, absolute hats off to Team Virginia. They showed up, as you said, in a tournament that I think a lot of people just wrote off the instant the teams were released, and Virginia never said die, you know, and absolute props to them, all the players on that team. SoCal, I mean, we've said everything I think there is to be said about Team SoCal. They were dominant, absolutely just dominant in the last two rounds. In their two matches last week, their two matches this week, they lost, what, a total of four maps, I believe? They won 7-0 against Stateless, 7-1 against Florida, 7-3 against five maps, 7-3 against Ohio, and then 7-1, 7-0 against Virginia. I mean, this team is just incredible. They have some of the best players in the game, and they came out and showed up, and it was what everybody expected to have happen, but you just have to give a lot of praise to Team Virginia, a lot of praise to Team Ohio, and really, you know, a lot of teams came out and showed up their best in this tournament, and we did have some great matches. Sadly, you know, the grand finals not really being one of them, other than the performance from Vaxxay in this match and the performance from SoCal overall. But I think we've had some cool moments in the tournament, even though some of the matches definitely ended up a little more one-sided than we would have liked.
Yeah, so, I mean, I guess we do have to kind of end the stream the proper way. I mean, ultimately, you know, everyone, your winners and the ultimate congratulations to South California. As much as we talk about, you know, Virginia playing an exceptional match, South California was a force to be reckoned with for the entirety of this tournament. Even when they did lose, they, you know, went up against insane team performances. But, you know, a good job to them. Vaxxay almost just FC'd the Big Black on the last section of the map here. But, you know, a GG well played
for South California in the end. And, you know, thank you so much to every team that came out this year. I should probably be letting Aaron say this, but really, you know, we appreciate like every year people coming out for this tournament. So it's always fun to see who shows up year after year. And, you know, we had a good set of lineups this year, and every single state had improvements and better players and new players, and so much, you know, passion for this game was shown in this tournament this year. I'll let T1G sign you off, but very well played from SoCal.
Yeah, I think, you know, every year we come out to USC, and I think we have a pretty good time of things. You know, we got to see SoCal 2017 in a really epic match. We got to see some incredible matches 2018, 2019 with NorCal repeating last year, winning both those. And then, you know, SoCal coming out here with this dominant performance. But I think every year we get some new faces in the tournament. We get some new players showing up. And really putting forth great performances, people like Utsuha, for instance, from Ohio this year, or guys like Abraham R, unexpected coming in, who hadn't even been, you know, who aren't even U.S. flag players, but, you know, moved here or from, you know, a territory. You get to see some cool people coming out and playing in a really fun tournament. And really, at the end of the day, I think that's what this is all about. You know, we have a great staff team. We have a lot of great players. It's just a fun concept. You know, we've got the teams from the United States just going at it against each other, and we've had, I think, a lot of fun. I know I've enjoyed streaming and commentating the matches this year. I think we had a lot of fun with all of our matches on stream. We had enjoyable commentary, and it's another year of USC in the books, and another, you know, really resounding victory for a California team. But was high quality Osu being played, excuse me, and couldn't do it without all of you guys in chat who have made really the most amazing streams we've ever had at this tournament. I never expected to see an Osu tournament stream outside of OWC with, you know, what, 1,200, 1,500 viewers. So it's really been incredible to see the turnout, and it's been really enjoyable. And definitely a big shout out to Dada, the co-host, to Chillier, to Will for doing a lot of commentary, Eric Fiery as well in the commentary booth. Kali, shout out as the number one ref this year. He hard carried the refing team alongside all the other refs. But, you know, I could name every name and it wouldn't feel like enough, because I owe a lot to everybody for making this team run as smoothly as it does, you know, from the graphics that you've done to everything else. So really great time, and GG, well played to SoCal. Thank you all for being here again for another amazing year at USC. And you know, who knows, we'll be seeing you guys probably in 2021 again, and hope to see some more great teams here. Hope to see everybody out again in a year's time for another iteration of one of the tournaments that I have the most fun with. So I think that's about all there is to it. It's been a fun run once again for another year, and see you all in 2021. For everyone here at USC, this is T1G, this is This One Guy, this is Aaron, whatever you like to call me. Signing off for a year.
Have a good one.